In this year's state finals, only two 13-0 teams are set to meet. Bloomington Central Catholic makes its seventh championship appearance. Aurora Christian features the most prolific passer in IHSA history. Next!
Drops it on the field.
Far from over, we still have one state champion to crown here tonight in Class 3A. Will it be Aurora Christian or Bloomington Central Catholic? Hello again, everyone. I'm Scott Leber, your field reporter for tonight's game. Glad you could join us here on the IHSA Network. Of our four championship games today, this is the only one that involves two undefeated teams. Aurora Christian in the regular season reigned over the private school league and has continued to march right through the playoffs. The guys, the Eagles, have followed the lead of their head coach, who is no stranger to anybody who's followed the NFL over the years, Don Beebe, the former great receiver of the Buffalo Bills and the Green Bay Packers. Also, Bloomington Central Catholic coming in here tonight with some unfinished business. Last year, they were the state runners-up after losing to Driscoll. Tonight, they are determined, the Saints, to come out of here on top and claim another state championship. Right now, let's go up to the booth with Lee Hall and Greg Bradshaw.
All right, Scott, thank you very much, Greg Bradshaw. This is the nightcap tonight, so to speak, and we're very excited to see these teams go at it.
We got two great teams, two undefeated teams, two great quarterbacks, two great offenses. We'll find out if we can play defense tonight, but it's going to be a great show.
It's a long road to Champaign, 4 weeks of playoffs to get here. Let's take a look first at how Central Catholic got here. Easy win over St. Thomas More in round one. Mount Zion gave them a good look in round two. Great quarterfinal comeback. That was a 21-17 final, actually. Quincy Notre Dame led that game 17-0, and then an easy one over Breeze Modern Day. For Aurora Christian, they beat Plano, a tough game against Coal City. Upsetting, I would say, Addison Driscoll, a team that had won seven straight state titles, and a close one over Richmond Burton last week.
Yeah, they have had some struggle in the playoffs, but they've made the plays when they need to, and they've been led by their great quarterback, Jordan Roberts, and he's a special one.
All right, let's take a look at the key players for tonight's ball game. First, for the visitors, the Saints of Central Catholic, their all-state quarterback, Adam Retzholz.
Yeah, they have their own answer. Adam Retzholz, he's been here before. He was here last year. Really has matured a lot. We're looking forward to a great night from him. He's got to lead this offense, which is pretty balanced.
Plays free safety and a guy that will play up front on both sides of the ball for Central Catholic, but is our key defensive player. That's Joe Ring.
Yeah, big Joe Ring. He's a big guy. He's going to get the pressure tonight on Jordan Roberts. He can stop the run, but really we want to see if he can rush the passer tonight. There he is right there. He's a good athlete, big, strong kid, and he's got his hands full tonight getting pressure on the quarterback.
And for Aurora Christian, well, you don't root for teams during the playoffs when you're in our business, but we really look forward to seeing Jordan Roberts tonight.
Yeah, he's done everything. He's thrown for over 9,300 yards, the leading passer in the history of Illinois, and over 123 touchdowns you see there. Does a lot of real smart things. You'll see him make real good decisions tonight.
And along with Central Catholic, our defensive player also plays offense. We'll see Lewis Gaddis run the ball tonight. He's also our key defender Aurora Christian.
Yeah, he's a linebacker, and he's going to have a lot of pressure on him. He's got a mirror Retzholz tonight, so we'll see if he can stop the run and be in pass coverage also to knock down the ball in the passing game.
All right, two 13-0 teams going at it here for the 4A State Championship, Bloomington Central Catholic and Aurora Christian, and we will have the starting lineups. Now let's go to our public address announcer.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, here are the starting lineups for the Class 4A State Championship. First, on defense for Central Catholic High School, led by head coach Bobby Mays. At defensive end, number 85, Adam McIntosh. At defensive end, number 84, Dylan Johnson. Defensive tackle, number 70, Joe Ring. Defensive tackle, number 60, Austin Sherwood. Linebacker, number 44, David Murray. Linebacker, number 4, Sean Stokes. Linebacker, number 3, James Hendricks. Linebacker, number 2, Brendan McCracken. Defensive back, number 11, Blake Rave. Defensive back, number 14, Ben Heaton. And defensive back number 9, Adam Rebholt. And now the starting offense for the Aurora Christian Eagles. First, meet head coach Don Beebe. Wide receiver number 82, Matt Morse. Wide receiver number 1, David Zilke. Fullback number 44, Luis Solorio. At quarterback number 10, Jordan Roberts. At halfback number 31, Lewis Gaddis. At left tackle number 52, Braxton Warner. At left guard number 57, Dean Griffin. At center, number 78, Andrew Hubert. At right guard, number 53, David Benson. At right tackle, number 56, Dylan Smith. And at tight end, number 33, Eric Anderson.
And those are our starting lineups. Today's coin flip and captain's meeting brought to you by Walgreens. Walgreens is a proud sponsor of the IHSA's Do What's Right, Good Sportsmanship campaign. There you get a look at some of the Aurora Christian fans on hand here tonight. And there's the coin flip and captain's meeting. Central Catholic won the coin toss. They deferred, so Aurora Christian will start with the ball. And we will see Mr. Roberts from the get-go here, Greg Bradshaw. And as a former quarterback, I'm sure you're looking forward to seeing him tonight.
Yeah, I really like the offense that Coach Beebe runs. Very controlled passing game, three-step drop, and he usually gets the ball to the open people.
Clear skies here in Champaign tonight. A little bit cooler than what we had this afternoon, obviously, but still a beautiful night for high school football. What a great 3A game we just saw between DuCoin and Illini West. Hate to see a team lose a game like that.
It came down to the very last play, basically, of the game, and great execution. And I hope we see something like that in this game. Great high school football game.
And there's a look at the maps. Bloomington, of course, just about a half hour, 45 minutes up the road, depending on how fast you drive. And Aurora, right outside Chicagoland area. This is the first Aurora area team to advance to the title game in football since the start of the playoffs back in 1974. So the entire Aurora community fired up for this Aurora Christian team. Kendall Cox will kick it off for Central Catholic, and we are underway in our 4A state title game. And good coverage that time by Central Catholic. Matt Morse with the 12-yard return for Aurora Christian. The Eagles will start on offense from their own 17-yard line. There you get a look at the Central Catholic Saints defenders. They were here a year ago and lost to Driscoll Catholic 48-24 in the 4A state championship game. Aurora Christian ended Driscoll Catholic's run through the playoffs just a couple of weeks ago. Jordan Roberts now goes to work under center. Hands to Gaddis, not much there for him. Maybe a loss of a yard. Here's a look at the Aurora Christian offensive line. Warner, Griffin, Hubert, Benson, and Smith up front, plowing the way in the holes for Jordan Roberts, Lewis Gaddis, Matt Morse, their leading receiver, David Zelke, who's a great tandem with Morse. Zach Koppel is a wide receiver, Eric Anderson tied in. Second down and 10, they give him no gain on that first play, and Central Catholic comes across the line. Might be Austin Sherwood.
Dead ball, encroachment, defense, 5-yard penalty.
That's a big break for Aurora Christian there. A lot of momentum, a lot of excitement on a defensive front, coming out, getting a good stop early, and then jumping off sides. Give them a little breathing room here on second down.
Check that. That was big Joe Ring getting across the line too early. Second and 6 for Aurora Christian. Roberts back to throw, he hands it off instead. Gaddis breaks one tackle and gets first down yardage and more down at the 37-yard line. Lewis Gaddis with the run.
Yeah, Gaddis is their man. They're going to give him the ball a lot today. He's the only one, really, that runs the football for Aurora Christian. The next leading rusher is Jordan Roberts, really, when he scrambles. So Gaddis is the workhorse on offense. Nice little draw play. Get him with some breathing room out to the 37-yard line.
Take a look at our Country Insurance and Financial Service starters there for the Central Catholic Saints. First down and 10 now for Aurora Christian from the 37-yard line. Gaddis is in motion. Roberts all alone now in the shotgun, rolls right, looks deep. Morris was the intended receiver, but it's off the mark, and it'll bring up second down.
I don't know if there was a little mix-up between Roberts and Morris there, but Roberts was throwing it off to the sideline, and Morris looked like he was maybe going deep. A little miscommunication, but it's second down. Huddle and bring it back.
Well, you can really hear the coaches down on the sideline encouraging their team. Aurora Christian now second and 10. The give to Gaddis. He cuts it back inside. David Murray was there and drops him for a loss of a yard. Number 44, David Murray, is a 5'10 senior. He played here a year ago for the Saints. There you get a look at allowing just over 100 yards rushing per game. That brings up third and 11.
Great play by Murray there. It looked like there was going to be a gain. There was an opening, but Murray closed it down outside in, made a nice tackle, bringing up third and long.
Third and 11 from the 36. First test here for the Central Catholic Saints defense. Roberts stands at his own 31. Back to throw, the all-time leading passer in IHSA history. Throws it intended for number 33, and it's off his hands.
That's Eric Anderson. That was actually a good throw by Roberts, right in the hands. Just couldn't handle it. Anderson couldn't handle it, and they're going to have to punt it away. But actually good execution, just a simple out route, and he couldn't hold on.
Jordan Roberts is the punter. Ben Heaton is back to return, standing at his own 34-yard line for the Saints, wearing all white tonight in the gold helmets. Aurora Christian in the red. Roberts kicks it left, and it will settle at about the 33-yard line. That's where the Central Catholic Saints will take over after a punt of 32 yards from Jordan Roberts. No score here in the first quarter. Back after this on the IHSA TV network. We are back in Champaign, Bloomington Central Catholic, and Aurora Christian no score. First possession now for the Saints of Bloomington Central Catholic. Adam Rebholz, the senior quarterback, under center as we get going here. The give is to Connor, and he'll be stopped for a loss of two. Brad Connor, 5'10", sophomore. He's really had a good sophomore season. 160 attempts, 753 yards, and 14 touchdowns for the sophomore.
That was a great play on defense. I think that's a big question tonight. How can the Aurora Christian defense match up against this high-powered offense from Central Catholic? So that's a good start for that defense.
Second and 12 now. Rebholz, here comes the pressure. He dodges the rusher. Here's the completion to Dylan Johnson. He's still on his feet at the 35. Steps inside at the 30, the 20. Can he get into the end zone? He does! Dylan Johnson! The touchdown catch, 67 yards. No flags on the play.
Wow.
What a run by Dylan Johnson, the senior. And what a story for him. His father died 70 days before the season started. It's been an emotional year. Bobby Mays, the Central Catholic head coach, told him something's going to happen this season that's going to be attributed to your father. And that
could be
right
it.
There could be it. The first touchdown, he scored the first touchdown of the year for the Saints. He scores the first touchdown of the 4A state championship. The kick by Cox is up and no good.
Well, here's a look at the play. First of all, Adam Rebholz, what a great play to avoid the rush. Then he keeps his eyes downfield, throws a strike to Johnson, and then Johnson takes it in the rest of the way. Right here, he gets a nice block, a great cutback, and then turns on the speed. all the way. Great start for Bloomington Central Catholic. Here's another look from a different angle. Just a nice throw right on the money. Good block.
Good block by
right
Ben
there.
Heaton.
And then he turns it on, makes a cutback move right here, and he's gone. That's a great start for Central Catholic.
The Saints with a 6-0 lead, and we saw an extra point almost become a big deal in the 3A state title
right.
game. Will it factor in here tonight? So Aurora Christian, the Eagles, fall behind very early on the big play from Reb Holtz to Dylan Johnson. 67 yards on that touchdown. Dylan Johnson's 10th touchdown of the year. Cox to kick it away. Morse chases it down. Smart play by Morse right there to let it bounce out of bounds and get the penalty against Central Catholic.
It'll come out to the 35-yard line. That's a big difference. He picks that up. He maybe gets out to the 10 or 15. Instead, he gets it out on the 35 and opportunity.
Very heady play by the junior Matt Morse.
Well, he's a big play guy. Last week, he had a huge 98-yard kickoff return against Richmond Burton.
Free kick infraction, kicking team. Ball put base at the 35-yard line. First down.
Let's go! That's Timothy Kiefer, our referee. Joining him, Robert Ibarra, Dennis Doyle, Jeffrey Maka, and Jeffrey Rutledge. Congratulations to those gentlemen in the stripes calling tonight's ball game. Aurora Christian will try again. Roberts 0 for his first two passing. He's back to throw again, has a lot of time. Looking deep, Heaton there on the coverage, almost hauls it down. Ben Heaton on the coverage. The intended receiver was David Zilke on the far side. There's a look at the Central Catholic scoring drive. It didn't take long. Two plays, 67 yards, all of them on the pitch and catch from Reb Holtz to Johnson.
Yeah, you got a good look right there at what Jordan Roberts likes to do. He likes to take the chances, likes the home run ball. Morse and Zelke got some good speed, and they like to throw it out down the field, give him a chance to run underneath those deep balls.
Second and 10. Here's the give to Gaddis. He popped a good run on the first drive, and gets about 8 yards there. That was, people might be looking at that graphic and say, a 67-yard drive, 69-yard touchdown, how do you do that? Well, the Saints lost a couple of yards,
you go
right?
backwards on your first play.
Yep.
But we saw in that touchdown the escapability of Reb Holtz, and that's something he's added this year, his strength and mobility. And that's one of the challenges that Aurora Christian has to deal with this game.
Saints show blitz. Roberts checks out of it. He's got receivers, twin receivers both sides. And a quick little out pattern is complete for a first down as they near midfield. Here's the keys to the game.
We just talked about a pocket Reb Holtz, which means keep him in the pocket. Don't let him escape and get out because he's dangerous. We already saw it. Secondly, Aurora Christian wants to hit some of those home run balls like we just saw up the sideline. They need to have some big plays. And thirdly, they need to get some turnovers. They cannot stop. It's going to be tough for them to stop this offense. They need to create some turnovers.
Roberts hands off. Gaddis met by a host of Central Catholic tacklers. Murray was there along with Joe Ring for the Saints. This Saints defense stepping up here in the early going.
They tried to run a little inside trap play, and that the inside line play of Joe Ring really stopped it, closed it down. No place for Gaddis to go. Tried to bounce it out and got a no gain.
Second down and 10. Ball at the 49-yard line. 7:45 to play and ticking here in the first quarter. Central Catholic leads 6-0. Roberts back to throw. Has Zilke at the 45. Steps out of bounds. Just past the yardage marker. I think he looked down and saw that. And that's good play by David Zilke, number one, 5'10 wide receiver, senior for the Eagles.
I think we'll see a lot of this formation that they just ran. It was an empty backfield, which means there's no running backs in the backfield. They spread everybody out, and then Roberts takes a quick drop, usually three steps, finds the open receiver within 5 to 7 yards of the line of scrimmage, and then they run to get some extra yards after the catch. That's one of their favorite formations.
So Central Catholic comes up with the big play. Aurora Christian putting together a nice little drive here. Trips receivers left. Roberts back to throw. Looks across the middle. Morse had his hands on it but couldn't hang on. And it's Blake Rave with the coverage for Central Catholic, number 11.
Nice defense by Rave here. Here's Roberts. He does a little pump fake and then comes to the slant across the middle. It looked like Morse might grab it, but Blake comes in there with his hand and knocks it out. Good defense. Not giving them much room. Got to stay tight to Morse. He's Roberts' favorite receiver.
Morse needs just one touchdown to become the 13th receiver in Illinois history to catch 20 touchdowns in a season. Second and 10. Roberts. Oh, and what a big hit by Adam Rebholz after the completion to Zach Koppel, the 5'9 senior. He took a hit and hung onto the ball.
Yeah, he did. Again, we got the empty formation. Roberts takes a three-step drop, sees Koppel uncovered, but not for long, because there comes the big hit. Mr. Rebholz comes in and lowers the boom.
That's your All-State quarterback right there.
That's right.
Whoa. Whoa.
He doesn't just throw it. He hits, too.
That was a molar rattler right there. Third down and one. Big play early here for Aurora Christian. Roberts under center, hands to Gaddis. And Don Beebe says, we go as Gaddis goes, and they go to him right there for the first down.
Yeah, they're known as a passing team, but Gaddis has 1,300 yards on the year. He's averaging 7.5 yards a carry. They do run the football. They're just not super imaginative. They line him up straight behind Roberts, and they just give it to him. But he finds a way to get yards. He's been very successful all year.
Seventh play of the drive for the Eagles at the Bloomington Central Catholic 29. Here comes the blitz. The throw intended for Morse is over his head, and it'll bring up second down. Central Catholic's going to try and put a lot of pressure on Jordan Roberts tonight, try and change up defenses, try and make him move, throw off his back foot, kind of make him uncomfortable.
Yeah, that's one of the keys of the game. They do want to rattle him and get him a little bit off balance. You don't want to let Jordan Roberts get in rhythm, because he is really deadly, and he moves that offense quickly. So they want to keep bringing different linebackers and sometimes bring corners off the edge to keep him unsettled back there.
Second and 10, Gaddis, the lone running back, on the draw and around the corner. Nice job defensively that time for Central Catholic. I didn't catch the number. It was 85. Adam McIntosh coming around the corner and catching Gaddis in the backfield before he could get across the line of scrimmage. Drops him for a loss of one.
Yeah, very slow developing play that time. They ran that play earlier, better timing. That one just took a little too long, and Bloomington Central Catholic read that, minus yardage.
Third and 11 for Jordan Roberts. Looks downfield. Here comes the rush. He's hit as he lets go of it, and it's incomplete. The pass was intended for Eric Anderson. Was that Joe Ring that put a pop on Roberts?
That was actually Adam McIntosh. Did a great job coming in again, getting pressure on Roberts. They brought an outside linebacker, and the tackle went off to block the outside linebacker, leaving McIntosh open and got pressure on Roberts. Big play here, fourth and 12, going after it. Got trips to the right and single Zelke down here all by himself.
Fourth and 12. Here comes the whistle. And Aurora Christian will call timeout. Central Catholic leads Aurora Christian 6-0 in the first. Back after this, timeout on the IHSA TV network. Six nothing, Central Catholic leads Aurora Christian. Hey, Champagne, are you hungry? Quiznos delivers from their location at Neil and John Streets. Quiznos, delicious, fresh, and fast. Right to your door, Quiznos, Neil and John Street delivers. Call them now. Deep throw on fourth and 12, incomplete. And Central Catholic will take over on downs at their own 31-yard line.
Yeah, they're not real clicking yet. Roberts and Morse haven't clicked yet. Again, looks like maybe a little miscommunication. Central Catholic's getting pressure on Roberts. I think he's having to throw it just a little bit earlier than he'd like.
There's a look at the numbers coming in. Both quarterbacks about 60% as far as completion percentage goes. Great touchdown to interception ratio. 41 touchdowns this season for Jordan Roberts. Adam Rebholz has done a lot of damage on the ground. He's added that to his arsenal. We haven't seen it too much yet. There is a flag before the Saints can get underway here on offense, leading 6-0.
Set ball. Ball start on the offense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
That's one of the things you'll see tonight, and what happened there, Aurora Christian shifted on defense. They do a lot of movement. I think Don Beebe brings that from the NFL game. They're moving all the time on defense. You never know where they're coming from. They blitz in all different gaps. You just notice that all night. If you watch the defense, you'll see them moving around. Sometimes there's 7-8 guys in the line of scrimmage. Sometimes there's 3, just mixing it up all the time.
First and 15, Connor, the sophomore, trying to get his offensive lineman out of his way. He does. And he pops it out to about the 40-yard line. He'll be about a yard shy of the first down. Nice run that time by Brad Connor.
Yeah, here's Connor, just a misdirection play. You see the big lineman out front. Good block there by Johnson. Kind of picks his way and gets downfield. Nice pickup after the penalty, giving him second down and short. It's one of the things with this defense, they take a lot of gambles and leave some holes open. So you might see some big plays, but other times you'll see some negative plays.
David Murray, the lone back behind Adam Rebholz. He's checking at the line. Led the Saints here a year ago. Murray, and now Rebholz is his lead blocker. Murray steps inside, takes it out near midfield where he's brought down. He picks up 10. Now they mark it at the 50, a gain of 11 and a first down for the Saints.
Just a simple play here. Rebholz just pitches it out and leads out in front, getting everybody downfield. Nice gain. Murray looks like he's feel comfortable there. I think one of the things that it's going to be a great advantage for Central Catholic is Rebholz. He can read things, he can see things, he can change the line of scrimmage, so all that movement can play to their favor.
Rebholz back to throw now, has a man. It's Dylan Johnson again, fumbles it out of bounds, and it'll be marked at the 39-yard line. A break there, he fumbled it out of bounds after a gain of 11.
But he fumbled it forward just enough for the first down.
I think they work on that.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Rebholz looked really comfortable in the pocket tonight. He just looks real calm in there, making good decisions, delivering the ball on time.
There you get a good look at Bobby Mays, his 17th year as head coach at Central Catholic. That's his brother Steve, who you just saw on TV not too long ago, right there in the shorts. Nice guy, not very smart out there in shorts tonight,
I'll
is he?
I'll tell you. He's a lot tougher than the guys up in the booth now, I'll tell you that.
Got that right. First and 10 at the 39. Murray in the end. He's down at the 30, inside the 30, down to the 25, 26-yard line. And that's a pickup of 13 for David Murray and a first down for the Saints.
Nice trap play.
The Diesel.
There. Yeah.
They call
he's
him the Diesel.
Man, and he's carrying the load tonight. That was a great play, just a nice little trap block by their guard, and Murray fouled it up. Good game.
Fifth play of the drive here. The Saints scored on a big play. Now they're moving it a little bit more methodically, but getting yardage down the field. The Eagles show blitz. Here's Murray the pitch. Rebholz the lead blocker. He got his man, too. Murray takes it down to the 11-yard line, a 15-yard run. And how about the blocking ability of Adam Rebholz? He took out the man he was aiming for. That was Ryan Parrick, who he pancaked.
Yeah, we've seen him throw. We've seen him make a big hit on defense. Here you'll see him come out and block for Murray. Nice block. And these are audibles. Rebholz is making audibles at the line of scrimmage. They had every man covered. That's the second time they've gone to this pitch play when every man's been covered on the line of scrimmage.
That's three straight plays that have picked up first downs for the Saints. First and 10 from the 11. Max in the eye. Here's the give to Connor. He's met in the backfield, keeps his feet, and stumbles forward and will lose about a yard. Here's our Country Insurance and Financial Services keys to the game for the Saints.
Well, Central Catholic wants to take the runaway, wants to take Gattis and that whole running game out, so they give him only one dimension, that's the pass, and then they want to get pressure, and they've been doing that. They've been getting to Roberts, and then lastly, they want to win the specialties. Unfortunately, they've already made one mistake on the specialty game. They missed the extra point, but they need to win the specialties tonight.
Second and 11. Rebholz, quick drop, picked off! That's Gattis with the interception, and he's brought down at the 17-yard line. Well, we talked about Lewis Gaddis, how we were going to see him running the ball, and you called him as the defensive key player of the game for the Eagles, and he comes up with a huge play there.
Yeah, he was in the right place at the right time. You'll see just a quick slant, and they want to throw it down to the bottom of your screen. A great job by the defensive lineman making the block. That's number 78, Andrew Hubert, and Gaddis is in the right spot.
Hubert got a hand on it.
Yep, and then he comes out. Gaddis makes a nice little return. That's what they need to do. They need to get turnovers. They're going to bend but not break is what they want to do tonight.
Big defensive play for the Eagles. Now they take over at their own 17-yard line. Roberts feeling some pressure. McIntosh had him, couldn't hold on. Here's Johnson gathering him from behind, and he just about gets back to the line of scrimmage. I believe he did. Adam McIntosh, number 85, almost had Roberts but couldn't hang on.
There's guys coming from every direction on Roberts here. Does a nice job escaping, breaking tackles, makes a nice little cut here, but there's just too many white shirts. They are all over Jordan Roberts right now, and Coach Beebe better find a way to protect his quarterback.
He is 3-for-10 so far in this game and feeling some pressure here. As the first quarter winds down, he rolls right, throws it to Morse, and well over his head again as he was forced out of the pocket. The Saints coaching staff said we've got to get a big push from our four guys up front on defense. That's Austin Sherwood, Joe Ring, Dylan Johnson, Adam McIntosh, and they're bringing the heat a little bit here. And there you get a look in the trenches, and Aurora Christian a little bit smaller than the Central Catholic front four.
Yeah, only 194 pounds per man up front for Aurora Christian. That's why you'll see a lot of three-step quick passing game from Aurora Christian.
Johnson from a shotgun. Here comes McIntosh again. He gets it away. Zilke has it. He's got a first down, and he's down at the 32-yard line. David Zilke, the 5'10 senior, a 16-yard reception, and the Eagles get out of danger there on third down.
Excellent throw and catch, and now you see why Jordan Roberts is one of the leading passers, or is the leading passer in the state of Illinois history. He stood in the pocket, took the hit, and delivered the ball, strike to Zilke, first down. Excellent job by Jordan Roberts. He's going to have to do those kind of things tonight with this pressure if they're going to be successful.
Zilke came from out of nowhere. Don Beebe is amazed at how well he's improved from his junior to senior year. Here's the give to Gaddis. He's met right about the line of scrimmage. Dylan Johnson pushes him back. He'll get forward progress to about the 34-yard line. Pickup of two.
Nice job by Dylan Johnson and Sean Stokes coming up from his linebacker position.
Second and eight.
Coach Beebe giving a little bit of run look, I think, just to keep them honest, but he's going to want to put the ball up in the air here.
Don Beebe says, we go as Gaddis goes. 25 yards rushing so far for Gaddis. Here's a throw to the left side, well off the mark. Roberts has been had a couple of throws here so far that haven't been close.
Yeah, I think it's timing. I think right now they're getting pressure on him, so it's just throwing the timing off just enough, because these are all timing routes. Three-step drop, hit my back foot, and throw. And if you got pressure, it causes a little bit of that timing to be off and causes those incompletions.
Third down and eight for the Eagles from their own 34-yard line, trailing 6-0 in the final minute of the first quarter. Roberts has a man, and boy, is he lambasted at the 40-yard line. It was Koppel, and there was Adam Rebholz again to put the hurt on him.
We saw the same
twice.
Play earlier.
Same two guys.
Same play, and here he comes and just lowers the boom. What a hit. Clean hit, shoulder pad to shoulder pad. Great play by Adam Rebholz. Look at him. He knows it.
Yeah.
He's watching it on the screen.
Looking.
That's the one thing you can do when you're in the state championship. You can watch the replays on the screen.
You can look up at the TV, you bet.
That was a great shot, guys.
Just talking to him, he has matured so much from last year now that he is a senior. Roberts will kick. Ben Heaton is back at his own 37-yard line. Roberts, the left foot. David Murray waving people away, and it will roll dead. And Central Catholic will take over at their own 36-yard line, a punt of just 26 yards. So not a great punt there from Roberts. He averages almost 40 yards a punt.
Yeah.
We do have a flag on the near sideline. You get a good look at Jordan Roberts. And we will talk it all over and get it figured out downstairs. Personal foul on Central Catholic.
Wow, 15 yards. I didn't see it.
The flag is on the near sideline at the Aurora Christian 41.
Personal foul, receiving team, 15 yards from the end of the kick, will be first down.
Well, there you go. That's a tough one for Central Catholic. They had the ball at pretty good field position, and now they hurt themselves with the penalty and start on their own 26.
Yeah, I'm not sure what happened there, but referee Kiefer was emphatic.
Yes.
The way he said that, he was a little angry, it looked like.
There's another one of the Mays brothers. That's Mike Mays. Bobby, Mike, and Steve Mays. They had another brother who played quarterback at Central Catholic back in the 80s. First and 10 from the 26. Here's the pitch to Connor. Rebholz leading the blockers again. And Connor takes it out to the 25-yard line after a pickup of five.
Great job by Zach Koppel coming from his cornerback position to take on the lead blocker there and turn the play in for his buddies to come from the inside. Oftentimes that goes overlooked, the corner play coming in and taking on those big lead blockers to force them in to the linebackers that get to make the tackle.
Second and six for the Saints. This will likely be the last play of the first quarter. Rebholz back to throw. Feels pressure, gets it away quickly. Tipped by Zach Koppel. The intended receiver was Dylan Johnson. And that won't be the last play of the first quarter. There's 4 seconds left after the incomplete pass.
You can see the blitz coming in here. They got pressure on Rebholz. He gets rid of it. And just a great play, good effort by Johnson there. But the hand of Koppel just tips the ball. Ooh, that was close. Man, awfully close.
Koppel has taken a couple of pretty good hits and showing no ill effects there. Third down and six for the Saints of Central Catholic. 4 seconds to go here in the first quarter. They lead 6-0. Rebholz back to throw. Here comes pressure from the backside. He fumbles. Central Catholic falls on it. Now it's loose and pops free. Dylan Johnson
picks it up. They
haven't
blown the whistle
yet. No whistle.
Oh, yes, they did.
Yes, they
did. Wow.
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 That is a bad break for the Saints.
It did not look like they were going to blow the whistle.
Bobby Mays is livid on the sideline. We have one official standing and spotting the ball, but I didn't hear a whistle. There's a flag down here on the near side. Bobby Mays not happy with the activity on the field right now at this point. There's no time left on the clock in the first quarter.
And then there was a late flag thrown well after the whistle, so I don't know if they're going to call a late hit, but there was so much action going on.
People
there was a lot
going on.
They weren't
on.
Stopping.
Yeah.
They kept playing, and so that's really a tough call if that's the case. Very confusing play.
The players down there, I don't think, heard the whistle because Johnson kept going.
Yeah, I don't know what they're going to call here.
Let's see.
We have a fumble recovery by White, which will be fourth down. There is no flag on the play.
Okay, that's fourth a good down. Call. I think that's a good call, Lee, because I think people were playing hard and they didn't know what was going on. Coach Mays doesn't like it, but I think that was a good call.
The Saints coaching staff still looking for answers here. We are through one quarter, no time left on the clock. End of one quarter, it's 6-0 Saints leading the Aurora Christian Eagles. Back after this local timeout. Lee Hall, Greg Bradshaw, welcome back to Champaign. Oh, that was a nice hat. Did you see that?
I didn't see it.
Go back. Look at that. Yes.
Wow.
That is awesome.
Yeah.
I don't know where you get those, but.
I thought you were talking about those stocking caps up there.
No. That's. The kind of Russian soldiers wear,
right.
I think.
Right.
We get ready to start the second quarter. It's 4th and 12 for the Saints. And that means it's a punt for Drew Talkington. Averaging just about 33 yards per kick. Should be good field position for the Eagles. And it takes a little bit of a Central Catholic roll there to the 45-yard line, a punt of 25. Here's our Menards stats, brought to you by Menards. Save big money at Menards. Pretty close so far on the scoreboard. First downs are even. Central Catholic, a little bit better numbers there. Almost 2-1, actually,
as far as yardage. You take away the 60-yard pass, and it's an even game. So.
69 yards, right. Time of possession, Aurora Christian winning that battle, and 3 of 6 on third down. They will start at the Central Catholic 45 as we get going here in the second quarter. Roberts, 4 of 14 passing. He'll throw it again. Early contact on Morse. Heaton on the coverage, and it's incomplete. Let's go down to Scott Leber.
Well, guys, I was listening to the officials explain that call to the coaches here on the Bloomington sideline, and they ruled that the umpire had indeed blown his whistle. I thought I heard a half-hearted whistle, kind of an indecisive whistle that was barely audible, and I think that's what the other officials heard, so they called the play dead, but really it was very difficult to hear anything.
Thanks, Scott. Roberts on second down, a little push pass to Gaddis. He has a first down, and he's down to the 33-yard line. Pickup of 12.
Nice little shovel pass, a little creativity there by Roberts. Nice block out front by number 52. Braxton Warner was out there, and nice result, 11, 12-yard gain, and first down.
Let's go back and take another look at that fumble, Greg.
Repples comes back. He gets flushed out of the pocket and doesn't see the pressure coming from behind. It gets knocked out. Then there's a scrum. Now we're playing rugby, and we don't know where the ball finally kind of squirts out.
I don't know how you blow a whistle on that.
Yeah, I don't know.
Here comes the rush by Central Catholic. Complete to Zilke, and he's down at the 32-yard line, a pickup of 1.
Oh, if Zilke would have kept his feet,
yes,
he could have walked into the end zone. They faked the bubble screen far out to the right and had Zilke coming back across the formation, and he just got tripped up, and couldn't keep his feet.
Jordan Roberts holds the IHSA record for points, 802. IHSA career record total yards, 9,387 coming into tonight. Total TDs, 123. He's got time now. He's flushed out left. Chased by McIntosh. Lets it fly. Penalty flag. And that's going to be pass interference against the Saints. Zach Koppel was the intended receiver. And I think they're going to flag Central Catholic for pass interference, and that's the call.
Or defensive holding.
Defensive holding.
Yeah, Roberts got flushed out to his left, and Koppel then saw that and started to scramble deep and had a step on the defender. Defender just grabbed a hold of him.
Holding on the defense. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Will result first down.
So from the previous line of scrimmage, they'll mark off the penalty, and it'll be first down and 10 for the Eagles.
You couldn't see it there, but he picked it up right after Blake Rave there grabbed a hold of Koppel.
From the 22-yard line, the Eagles look to take the lead. Nice pass over to Sean. Check that. Mitch Holtz into the ball game for the first time with the reception. Pickup of 15. What a nice little play by Jordan Roberts to bring the defense in and then throw it over the top of
little half roll here, screen back the other side, and look at Adam McIntosh hustle and make the game or the touchdown saving tackle. Great effort by McIntosh. 6'4", 215 out there running and catching the running back Mitch Holtz on that. Great effort by McIntosh. Good execution by Aurora Christian.
Brings up first and goal from the 7. Roberts gives to Gaddis. No, he keeps it himself. He faked it. Now he tries the little shovel pass, and there's nobody there.
Yeah, Roberts just didn't want to take the sack, the negative play, just throws it forward. Go back in the huddle, regroup, second down and 10. Good play by Roberts for second and 7. Here it is again. Little spin around move here, little fake. Here comes Roberts looking for his receiver. His receiver gets caught up there, and he just kind of throws it forward, and not much of a chance, obviously, for his receiver to catch it, but no negative play. Smart play, heady play by Jordan Roberts.
Bobby Mays, Central Catholic coach, arms crossed on the sidelines, second and 7. Roberts has a little trouble with the snap. Here comes the pressure. Tries to outrun it and does. Has a man in the end zone. Touchdown! Zilke with the catch. Roberts to Zilke, and we are tied.
There you see Roberts almost fumbles the snap going. He throws really hard across his body. Very tough throw. Great diving catch there by Zilke. Just a great effort by Roberts throwing across his body. And good catch. And with an extra point here, they'll take the lead.
42nd touchdown pass of the season for Jordan Roberts. The PAT is good. And it's the Eagles of Aurora Christian with a 7-6 lead here in the second quarter. Back after these local messages. Greg Bradshaw back in Champaign. 7-6 our score. Aurora Christian scoring on a six-play drive, 45 yards. As Justin Roberts with his 42nd touchdown pass of the season to David Zilke. Here's the kickoff, fielded by one of the upmen for Central Catholic. It's Blake Raven. He's down at the 31-yard line. His knee was down when he picked it up. And that's where the Saints will take over, trailing now 7-6.
Roy Christian's defense comes up big, gets the stop, the short punt, and they convert. Nice job by that Aurora Christian defense, giving that ball to the offense to go 45 yards for the score.
I don't think Bobby Mays agreed with that call either.
Yeah, and neither do the fans. We're hearing a little little boo birds here out of Central Catholic fans.
They trail it here 7-6. Saints take over. 13-0. Rebholz with the trouble with the snap and a flag on the play. I think it was blown dead. Well, it couldn't have been blown dead before the snap because he was backpedaling.
Dead ball. Ball start on the offense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Did that whistle seem late to you for a false
start? Yeah, I think the center may have what would you call that? Flinched.
Faked.
And when you flinch, they'll call that automatically. Even though there's a fumble, he flinched, so it's a 5-yard penalty for legal procedure. Kind of out of sorts right now, Central Catholic.
Yeah,
they need to get something going here.
Aurora Christian looked that way early. Now Rebholz throws it up down the far sideline to Heaton. Ben Heaton with the catch at the 49-yard line. That's a pickup of 23.
That's one way to do it. Let your quarterback throw a nice little fade up the sideline, one-on-one. A nice job, good catch. Here's a good look at it, just a nice little fade route. And Heaton does a nice job going up and getting it high, getting his feet in bounds. Nice game, first down.
Ben Heaton says that his quarterback has a feel for the game, and he had a nice feel, nice touch on that throw. Saints keep it on the ground that time. There's a look at the battle in the trenches, and Central Catholic has the reach. Aurora Christian has the LBs. Pick up a 5 that time for the Saints. Second and 5, ball at the 47. Backs in the eye. Rebholz back to throw. Look at that open ground around him. The pass is complete to Adam Curran. Did you see that pocket? My goodness, what a pocket. Rebholz had to throw out of to Heaton, or check that, to Adam Curran, Dan Curran rather. Pickup of 20 yards.
Nice little play fake here by Rep Holtz. Look at that. Nobody around him really. Be able to deliver the ball right on target. A great job by Curran catching the ball and turning it up. Excellent execution. Rep Holtz again looks very comfortable in the pocket.
He's thrown for 123 yards. Now he keeps it. This is what he's added to his arsenal this year. He has really run well with the ball on first and 10. He's down to almost the 20-yard line. Give him a pickup of 6.
You see this now on Saturdays and Sundays even now. This quarterback out of the shotgun being an effective runner, really a threat to run the ball now is these quarterbacks out of the shotgun. And Repholz is a good one. You see there his stats on the year, 520 yards, 5 yards a carry. That always includes sack yardage. So when you have a quarterback that gets a 5 yard plus average, that's pretty decent.
Third on the team in rushing. Fakes the handoff to Murray and keeps it himself. It's Repholz inside the 5, across the goal line, touchdown, Central Catholic. Adam Repholz, the 21-yard run, and the Saints are back on top.
Little fake to the running back. Repholz takes off. Just a real big, strong, athletic kid. Great job getting into the end zone. You can kind of see it on his face tonight. He just has that look of determination that he's just not going to be beat. He's not going to get pushed back. And nice job getting into the end zones there.
10th rushing touchdown of the year for Adam Repholz. And the Saints will go for 2 here, leading 12-7. It's Murray and Connor. Repholz throws. Ball was tipped, no interference, and incomplete on the two-point conversion try. It's no good. The Saints lead it 12-7 with 8:01 to go in the second quarter. Back after this on the IHSA TV network. Central Catholic didn't waste any time getting back in front. 5 plays, 69 yards, a minute 56. Repholz with the 20-yard run, his 10th touchdown run of the season. Point after, no good. 12-7, the Saints lead it. Cox will kick it off. It's Morse for Aurora Christian, picking it up at his 15-yard line. And he's down at the 22-yard line. There's a look at the playoff history we mentioned in the open, Greg. Great, rich history for Central Catholic. 21 appearances. There you look at their playoff record, 42-17. 3 titles, 3 second-place finishes, Aurora Christian. A new tradition for the Eagles as Don Beebe has taken over and done outstanding work in his 5 years, 49-10. They were 12-1 a year ago, 6 points shy of the state championship game. This year they made it to the carpet, and they trail here 12-7. Jordan Roberts back to throw, has a lot of time that time. Zilke's open. He caught it at the 45. He's gone. Touchdown Aurora Christian, 72 yards as the Eagles strike back.
We talked about the home run balls, Lee, and there it is. You'll see it here, the empty backfield, and we said this empty backfield's one of their favorite formations. Just went a little corner route. Puts the ball right in the money. Zilke runs underneath it. Not even close. No one within 10, 15 yards of him. Great play. Thanking the Lord there for his touchdown.
Zilke's second touchdown catch of the game. He's already over 100 yards receiving after that 72-yard touchdown strike. The extra point is up and good for Jake Van Gils. And it's a 14-12 Aurora Christian lead. Boy, been an exciting few minutes here, hasn't it, partner?
Yeah, you have two quarterbacks that just do not want to be denied tonight. Here you got the empty backfield like we talked about. Great protection. He stands in there, can easily see his receivers downfield. Zilke just one-on-one there, and it's tough to cover these guys one-on-one. They're quick, and it's just a great, great throw and catch right there. And just a really, really tough play. James Hendricks there has got a lot of tough duty there covering Zilke one-on-one.
72-yard pass play, and Aurora Christian takes the lead back. And the Saints defense knew this could happen. They come into this chip on their shoulder. They feel like, hey, people expect us to give up a lot of points. We don't plan on it. But this is a quick strike team with this kind of capability.
Yeah, that's the kind of game that I thought we'd see tonight. We have two great offenses. Wasn't sure how the defenses would be able to stack up against it. But it's been back and forth, though. We've seen some pressure put on the quarterback by both teams, and they're still holding their own, but it's tough to stop these big play receivers.
Aurora Christian kicks off with the 14-12 lead. Connor fields it at his own 12. Out across the 20 to the 25 and down at about the 27-yard line. 80 yards is the longest pass completion in a 4A game. That was 72 yards, 16-yard return there for the Saints. Look at that. We have had some scoring here in the last couple of minutes.
Yeah, it's almost like we got a little boxing match going here between Adam Repholz and Jordan Roberts. Okay, now it's your turn. Take your best shot. Now it's my turn. Take my shot. And it's back and forth right now. It's exciting football. Two great football players, two great teams battling it out here at the state championship.
Saints start from their own 27. Repholz on the option, keeps it. And he gets out to about the 35-yard line, pickup of 8.
You can see here, Coach Mays knows the horse that got him here, and that's Adam Repholz, and now he's starting to ride him a little bit. Not only is he throwing the ball, but they're running him a little bit more, and he's proven that he's a good gamble there on that run game. 8 yards, he's got to almost 30 yards rushing now and on 4 carries.
Second and 2. Trips receivers to the right for Repholz. Gives to Murray. He has good yards out to the 50-yard line across midfield and into Aurora Christian territory at the 49-yard line, a pickup of 16 for David Murray.
Here's a good look at it. Just a quick hitter right there to Murray. They had Repholz using him with a running game. Now they got a little misdirection with Mays right behind the big block. Good block there by the offside guard. And a great effort by Murray to get downfield, get it across the 50.
David Murray, 747 yards coming in, and he is about as hard to bring down as a 747. First and 10 from the 49. They keep it on the ground to Murray. He'll pick up a yard, maybe two. Those three touchdowns came in 2 minutes and 9 seconds of time on the clock. That is getting it done.
Yeah. Neither one of these teams will ever think they're out of it tonight. I don't care if you get up 2 scores or not, 3 scores. The other team believes they can score quickly and get back in the game. So I'm looking forward to a great finish to this football game.
A couple of big plays so far. 69-yard touchdown strike for Central Catholic. The one for 72 yards for Aurora Christian. Deep throw to Heaton is well over his head. Check that. That's Connor. He calls for a flag but won't get one.
Good coverage on the defensive side of the ball there by Aurora Christian. Nobody open. Repholz just throws the ball down the field. Got a good look at his arm there just on the run. Threw that ball about 45 yards downfield to throw it away. But good defense, defensive backfield by Aurora Christian.
This senior class for the Saints, 30-3 since 2006. They've never lost a regular season game. Last regular season loss was back in October of 06 to Prairie Central. Second straight unbeaten regular season for this team. Seniors haven't lost a regular season game. Adam Repholz leading the way for them on 3rd and 9 to Murray. He's met at midfield and dropped for a loss. Big tackle that time by Andrew Hubert, 5'11 senior.
Hubert smelled the screen out. You see the screen to the left-hand side, and he smelled it out, was right there, waiting for Mr. Murray to catch the ball. Nice hit. If Hubert's not there, it could be a big game, but he was reading that from the time the ball was snapped. Great job there.
4th and 11, Drew Talkington will be forced to punt for the Saints. Good rush that time by the Eagles. He gets it away, takes a Central Catholic bounce. And the Eagles will start at their own 21-yard line. Punt of 29. 4:44 to go, second quarter. An explosive second quarter for scoring. Aurora Christian with the 14-12 lead. There you get a look at what's transpired here today. Triopia, your 1A state champions, defeating Stark County. Immaculate Conception with a 36-17 win over Casey Westfield. And a fantastic finish, Illini West over DuCoin, scoring in the final minute to win that ball game 21-14. Congratulations to Jim Unruh and his team. That pass incomplete, intended for Morse. Roberts now 9 for 22. His completion percentage isn't as good as what it's been, but he's got two touchdown passes and 147 yards.
He's hitting the home runs. We talked about that earlier. That's what they want to do. They'll go short, 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 then take a chance on the home run, and that's been paying off for him all year, and it's paying off for him here tonight.
Got to look at Don Beebe looking at his play sheet. Three receivers to the near side. The give is to Gaddis. Keeps it on the ground. Maybe a little bit short of the first down, down at the 30. Pick up of nine that time.
Here's a good look at Gaddis running right up into your living room. Nice job here. He's a little disappointed. I saw him. He was frustrated because he thought he could get outside there. He just got tripped up, but a nice gain. Third down and one here.
Central Catholic fans making some noise on third and one. Four receivers for the Eagles. Roberts trying to draw the Saints offside. He keeps it himself, and it looks like he'll have plenty for the first down. With 4:01 to go here in the second. There's Don Beebe. Six Super Bowls, four with the Bills, two with the Green Bay Packers, and I was at the Super Bowl that he won with the Green Bay Packers.
And so was I. I was there too, yep. I didn't see you there, but I was there.
Really?
At New Orleans?
Yes.
Yeah, I was there.
Larry Bud Melman was there. Jordan Roberts up the gut. Picks up about three.
Now, Roberts doesn't run the ball that often. He is a little bit of a threat out of the gun, but most of the time he wants to throw it. Decent speed, but he's not the same kind of athlete that Repholz is.
There you get a look at Bobby Mays. He was quarterback for the Saints back in the mid-70s. He's got quite a coaching staff. We'll get more into that a little bit later. Second and seven. Roberts with time has Morse for the first down, but there's a flag back behind the line of scrimmage. And a Central Catholic player is down on the far side.
I think that's Blake Grave over there that came up to make the tackle on Morse. He's in pain too.
It's not Rave, I think it's Heaton.
Oh, it's not, it's Heaton? Oh yeah, here, there's Rave on the bottom there, that is Heaton.
Ben Heaton, the senior. There is a flag.
14, Ben Heaton is the injured player.
Aurora Christian with the 14-12 lead on a couple of touchdown passes from Jordan Roberts to David Zilke, and we hope Ben Heaton will be all right.
Looks like he's going to be okay.
Walking
That's
off
good.
Under his own power. That's always a good sign. Ashley Kingston, the trainer for the Saints.
Holding on the offense. 10-yard penalty, second down.
So it'll be second and 19 for the Eagles after the penalty.
We'll see if Roberts goes right back there, knowing now that Heaton's out. They bring in his backup. Don't know who's out there, number eight. For the
Dan
Saints.
Curran.
Yep, Dan Curran.
Second and 19. Roberts with time. Now runs right with nobody open. Has a man deep. It's Anderson, and it's off his tips, fingertips. Eric Anderson was wide, wide open.
Yeah, just creating something out of nothing here. Jordan Roberts looks over here to the left. He was trying to go over there to Curran. Nothing. Then he looks downfield. Anderson's wide open. Just kind of gets turned around and drops it. Oh, boy, that was a big play. There was nobody behind him. There's nobody. Well, You see number two there, Brendan McCracken coming over, but that was a big game.
As my friend Denver Johnson would say, he was so wide open, he looked like he was late for school. He was all alone. 2:57 to go, second quarter. Roberts, now a little pressure from the Saints. He runs right, throws deep for Morse. McCracken is there and a flag on the play. Looked like he was face guarding and didn't make a play on the ball. And it'll go against.
And a late hit,
McCracken.
Looks like maybe on the quarterback, roughing the passer. Here comes maybe the roughing the passer right here. Yeah, that was late. Yeah, that was a tough call on McCracken, but certainly that was roughing the passer.
So the penalty's hurting Central Catholic here in this ball game.
Well, if you didn't like the interference call, then you had the roughing the passer call. So that definitely was roughing the passer.
No doubt about that.
You got to protect those quarterbacks, Lee. You know that.
Yeah.
You
keep telling me that.
That's declined. Pass interference on the defense. That's accepted. 15 yards, automatic first down.
Here's another look at the pass interference call.
Quick look.
Yeah. That's all those guys downstairs get.
Yep.
Five penalties, 40 yards against the Saints in this one. First and 10 from the 38. Roberts looking deep again. Zilke turns one way and can't come up with it. Connor on the coverage for Central Catholic. It goes incomplete.
Roberts puts the trips to the right and then goes one-on-one with Zilke, tries to run the post corner. Good effort here by Zilke to come over the other shoulder, just can't do it quick enough. And it just falls just past his reach. Good concept, trips to one side, one-on-one to the other, just didn't get the job done. They'll come back to that though.
One knock against Jordan Roberts is people aren't sure about his arm strength, but he's thrown some pretty deep balls and some have been off the mark, but he's getting them there. This one way back across his body, intended for Anderson, is incomplete. Brings up third down.
They've run that one earlier time. They do the half roll to the right and come back to the screen. Well covered this time. You can fool me once, but never twice. And they were waiting for him out there for that play.
Third and 10 from the 38. The Saints would like to see a defensive stop here and get a chance to get another score before they go into the locker room.
Go Earwood.
Roberts with time again. Pass is incomplete, just behind the intended receiver, Zach Koppel. And just as soon as I say his arm strength looks all right, he underthrows one there.
This actually wasn't too bad of a throw, Lee. Again, this empty formation, which has been very successful. Guys are getting open. That ball really should have been caught.
Yeah.
Maybe just a little bit underthrown, but that ball was catchable. And just couldn't bring it down.
You quarterbacks think every ball's catchable. Come on.
That ball was catchable.
Yeah, you're right. That was.
But that empty formation has been very successful. They're really getting guys open out of that with nobody in the backfield.
Roberts to punt. Heaton is back out there for Central Catholic, and he'll let it bounce, and it will stop. Look at that. Just like I hit my wedge. Punt of 30 yards, and it stopped dead in its tracks at the 32. The Saints get the ball with 2:20 to go in the quarter and a chance to get in the end zone before they head to the locker room. Boy, it looked like it was going to be a shootout there for a while with three touchdowns in a 2-minute, 20-second span, but the defenses have stepped up here in the last few minutes.
But the potential is there. You just get a sense that at any time, either one of these teams can make a big play.
Don Beebe says the Saints on offense have no weaknesses. His Eagles try to stop him here. Here comes the rush. Rebholz avoids it, but not for long. He's chased down from behind by Lewis Gaddis.
There's Lewis Gaddis making his presence felt. First he gets flushed by Peter Carotis, and then you see Gaddis coming in there making the play.
Gaddis with the sack, 4-yard loss for the Saints. Second and 14. Rebholz gets pressure. Heaton back in there, makes the catch, still on his feet, looking for somewhere to go, going the wrong direction after getting out to the 34-yard line, a pickup of 6. That'll bring up third down and 8 with a minute 30 to play in the second quarter.
Nice throw by Repholz under pressure. Just gets it off. You can see him getting smacked. And then a great catch there by Heaton. Except, unfortunately, he runs backwards for about 4 or 5 yards and loses it. But brings up third and 8. Nice job by Repholz under pressure. Here you see he catches the ball about on a 43-yard line. Actually, not too bad. He only maybe lost a yard or two.
Aurora Christian takes timeout here with a minute 30 to go. On third down and 8, they're thinking, hey, we'll get the ball back and have a chance.
Yep.
You think they might try and throw one deep?
Well, with these offenses, they're not afraid to use their timeouts to give them a chance because they can move the ball very, very quickly.
Interesting to see the approach Don Beebe brings to the game, having been a professional NFL football player for so many years and bringing the knowledge and the nuances of that game to the high school level. Third and 8 for the Saints with a minute 30 to go in the second. Repholz has time, steps up, has Heaton. It's caught at the 48-yard line. Pickup of 20 and a first down for the Saints.
Well, that's one of the problems with calling timeout when you're on defense against a team like Central Catholic. They come back to bite you, and they're moving the ball.
Clock runs with a minute 19 to go. It's Heaton again. He catches it on his knees at the 44-yard line.
They have all three of their timeouts remaining.
Minute 5 to go, second quarter. Ball at the 44. Repholz on a roll. Looking deep, has a man, but overthrows him. The intended receiver was Dan Curran. And we've seen this. He throws an incompletion there, but we've seen this from Adam Repholz. We saw it last year in the semifinals where he completed 6 straight passes against Mount Carmel to clinch a victory. He will go out there and hit 4, 5, 6, 7 passes in a row. He can really get on a roll, and sometimes, you know, I say streaky. Now, that's not what you say.
I say rhythm. I think that's what happens. You get in a rhythm. You get some good protection. You get a couple of throws. You make some good completions. You get in that rhythm, and it's tough to stop when you get those good quarterbacks in their rhythm.
Third and 2. This time it's Curran. He's going to try and get out of bounds, but he'll be brought down at the 36-yard line. Zilke with the tackle. Pickup of 9 with 47 seconds to go, and the Saints will call timeout. And I meant the streaky in a good way,
yeah.
But you say it's rhythm.
I think that's how I would describe it. See, you could just see he has confidence in the pocket, delivers the ball, throws a nice ball. 9-yard gain.
And I asked Bobby Mays about it, and he says when I see him get in the pocket, get up, and throw off that back foot, that's when he really gets his confidence up, and he really, like you say, is in a rhythm. And he'll throw 10, 11, 12 passes complete in a row in practice,
right,
for the Saints. Here's a look at our schedule tomorrow. The Metamora Redbirds try to make it 2 straight state championships for Pat Ryan. They take on St. Francis at 10 tomorrow morning. Springfield Sacred Heart Griffin takes on Lamont in 6A at 1 o'clock. East St. Louis against Geneva in 7A. And then we'll wrap up the weekend with Hinsdale Central and Perennial Power Maine South. From the campus of the University of Illinois, beautiful, historic Memorial Stadium. 47 seconds to go, 1st and 10 for the Saints. They're driving here, trying to take the lead before the half. Repholz, deep, Heaton, beats the double coverage, and he's complete and down at the 1-yard line. The Saints will have it, 1st and goal from the 1 after the 35-yard completion to Heaton, who went out of the game moments ago, but he's come back with a vengeance. Repholz, a nice throw over 2 defenders.
I'll tell you what, that's a big-time throw, out and up. Good coverage, just a perfect throw and a better catch, and just a great effort. Here comes Repholz on the quarterback sneak. It's close. Wow.
No signal yet. It looks like they're going to mark him down about the 6-inch line with 22 seconds and counting. And now they'll finally blow the clock dead. Taking a long time to get untied there. 19 seconds to play. Boy, that was a great throw and a great catch by Heaton, too.
That was big time right there.
The Saints want timeout. They'll have one remaining. Bobby. Bobby's an emotional guy, can you tell? Take a look again at Adam Remholtz and Ben Heaton.
You're not going to see many better throws at this level. This is stuff that you see on Saturdays and Sundays right there. Just a great throw, a little pump fake over the outside shoulder. Nice, nice play. Both quarterbacks playing very well in the first half.
Adam Remholtz, 2,174 yards passing coming into this ball game with 25 touchdowns. He's at 192, 10 for 13.
Yeah, he's playing very, very well. Not only has he done that, he's had some nice runs, 6 runs for 25 yards and a touchdown. Playing defense, blocking. Right now, Remholtz is doing everything.
How about the two hits he laid on Zach Koppel? Will remember him for a long time.
I'm sure he read a lot about Jordan Roberts being this and that, and Adam came to show what he can do, and he's showing it tonight.
He has 19 seconds to get into the end zone, second and goal. Just a little bit further than the length of the football for the Saints. Murray, no problem. The Diesel rumbles into the end zone. And it's an 18-14 Central Catholic lead. Quick work by the Saints here in the closing moments of the second quarter.
You go back to when Coach Beebe called that timeout thinking, you know, with third and eight, we can get the ball back. Actually, that's a good play, but
it's a good idea, sure. It just didn't work this time.
Yeah, here's just this little look at that great job there by number 52. Who's that? That was a great block by Nathan Yelton on 77, Kerry Otis.
Saints go for two again. Remholtz with a man clinging to his shirt, gets it off, flag in the end zone, and we'll have to get that all sorted out. Dylan Johnson was the intended receiver. He's talking to the officials. Holding against the defense with 17 seconds to play.
Well, they'll get another shot at it now from the 1.5 yard line.
On the defense, half the distance to the goal, repeat the try.
Jay Dockauer, Jack Wambacher, Chris Highland, Nathan Yelton, Joe Ring, the big guys up front making the holes, giving Adam Remholtz the time to throw tonight for the Saints as they look to go up 20-14 here. He gives to Murray. Did he get in? Yes. Official on the far side signals good. The two-point conversion makes it 20-14. Central Catholic with 17 seconds to go here in the second quarter. Take another look.
It's very similar to the touchdown play, just a quick opener there to Murray, and he bangs it in. Really met the linebacker head on, just falls forward and gets the two-point conversion.
So the Saints get the quick score and go up 20-14 here with 17 seconds to go in the second quarter of play. We talk about that Central Catholic tradition. Second, or 2A champs in 82, 1A champs in 87, 3A champs in 94. They're trying to become the first school to win state championships in four different classes.
Yeah, they've had a great tradition at Bloomington Central Catholic, and they're showing tonight why they're one of the best programs in the state. But Aurora Christian's holding its own, first time here, and they're going toe-to-toe right now. It's been a great first half.
Kendall Cox will kick it away for the Saints. Well, that's one thing Don Beebe talked about. He bounces it down the middle. Oh, picked up by a big hoss right there. And still on his feet. How can you bring him down? That's Peter Kariotis. All 317 pounds of him.
They put him in the backfield, you know. He carries the ball. They put him in at fullback and give him the football sometimes.
And the defense runs the other way,
right? I tell
you
what, yeah, it's Refrigerator Perry. Go back all those years to 85.
2 minutes, 3 seconds on the drive for the Saints. 9 plays. That was a textbook drive there.
Well executed
in the final minute.
Drill. Yep. Yeah, excellent job.
Aurora Christian has 10 seconds left. I'm guessing they're not going to waste it. Roberts has 4 receivers out. Gaddis in the backfield. He's still got time. Clock ticking. He gets it to Zilke. He's still on his feet. The time has run out on the clock, and that is how the first half will end. They had Zach Koppel on the far side. They kind of faked the end around and showed a different look there, but that is how the first half ends. Central Catholic with the 20-14 lead. David Murray, the touchdown run. A really nice first half for Adam Rebholz, 10 for 13 passing, 192 yards, and the touchdown, 69-yard touchdown strike to Dylan Johnson that started the game. 20-14, our score. Scott Leber is downstairs with Bobby Mays.
Coach, an emotional first half for you for a variety of reasons. You going to make it through the second half?
We'll be fine. We'll be fine. We had some interesting things happen in that first half. Our kids fought through it, and I'll tell you what, we just got to find a way of stopping them.
What are you going to tell your kids in the locker room?
We just got to keep playing. They're not going to stop. They're going to score some more. We got to be, you know, try to defend them and stop them. We got to keep scoring because I think it's going to be a high-scoring game.
No, without doubt. Thank you, Coach. Good luck second half. Lee?
All right, Scott, thanks a lot. Thanks to Bobby Mays for joining us. Hope you're enjoying IHSA football here. Central Catholic leading Aurora Christian 20-14 at the half. Back after these local messages, followed by a network break.
Points on the board. 20 of them belong to the Saints from Bloomington Central Catholic, and they lead Aurora Christian 20-14 at the half. I'm Dave Fernhardt. Thanks for joining us in this game. In fact, thanks for joining us all day long. I'm joined here once again at the half by a couple of head coaches very familiar with high school football in Illinois, of course. This is Jason Kirby from Sherrard High School, and to his left, that's Scott Hamilton from Unity. And before we talk about the game as a whole, let's talk about individuals. First of all, for Bloomington Central Catholic, we spotlight the quarterbacks, Adam Rebholz.
Yeah, Adam's had a tremendous half and a very, very athletic kid. 10 for 13, 192 and a touchdown. And probably more impressive to me has been his ability to run and scramble and make plays with his feet. He's added another touchdown like that as well.
And he engineered that final drive when they needed it most in the final 2 minutes.
Yeah, and how about the pass down the sideline into double coverage? Perfect spot for it. So, I know the guys calling the game said it looked like a Saturday or a Sunday pass, and it was sure a good one.
You know, on the other side for Aurora Christian, Jordan Roberts came in with a higher publicity, and he's winging it around this field.
He is. 27 attempts, 10 completions, 153 yards and 2 touchdowns. Not good. I think, as Scott pointed out, he was able to make some plays with his feet by giving himself some more time as well. And a couple of his throwaways I thought were really good. A couple screens, rather than trying to throw it into coverage, threw an incompletion. That takes a young man that's been well coached.
Well, you know, when we were just looking at the numbers a moment ago, 10 of 27, and you might say, well, boy, that's not very good. But as you said, he avoided negative yardage.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of times in a high school situation right there, a kid would throw a pick, and it'd be a pick six. He was throwing the ball away, making great decisions, not throwing the ball into coverage, saw a ton of man free, never threw the ball into the man free coverage, and did a nice job with that.
Yeah, I think that, you know, a big play early in that game was the fumble or the not fumble. And, you know, I think the Central Catholics recovered from that. And, you know, what a big touchdown for them to end that half. And, you know, Aurora Christian called that timeout, hoping to get the ball back. And, you know, it's easy to second guess, you know, but it worked out for Central Catholic, and they were able to get out and get a big score by the half. And I believe it'll be their ball to start the second half.
We saw some of the numbers with the quarterbacks. We've got a whole lot more numbers when we come back, and we'll have that halftime stats and highlights coming up after this local break. Memorial Stadium here on the University of Illinois campus.
much of it refurbished. We talked to John Paul earlier on about Fighting Illini Spirit, the DVD you can get your hands on, tell you all about this stadium. But here in 2008, in the final weekend of November, it hosts the IHSA State Football Playoff Championships. Let's take a look at our first half stats brought to you by Menards. Save big money at Menards. And you saw a number of these numbers earlier. There's some big, 292 total yards, 193. That's some offense in the first half.
Yeah, it is. And a number of people said, Coach just got done talking about the fact that they need to continue to score because they look for the second half to be a shootout. It was similar to the last game that we talked about, just a couple fingertips away, it seemed like, from this being that shootout that we were thinking, instead of 14-12, much higher.
And yet only one turnover.
Yeah, and I think time of possession looks pretty similar. You know, turnovers is one for BCC, and I think that both teams are still trying to figure each other out a little bit. It's hard to get a real good flow for the game, and I think BCC's fullback appears to be an awfully good player, maybe make some big plays down the stretch for him.
That's David Murray. He's back, scored on that one-yard touchdown run to end the half, and that's what I wanted to talk about. This has been a strange game. You know, we thought they'd be going up and down the field. It was a defensive struggle first, and then a flurry of points, and it kind of settled down again. How is it that teams can go two quarters, 24 minutes, and still not really get a feel for each other?
Well, I think Coach made a great point in the fact that quite possibly they could be going in right now and discussing some things, that not only making adjustments, but talking to their staff about what adjustments need to be made. A lot of times as a head coach, you're going to get those points shot to you right then, and you're like, oh, good idea. You come out, and as you've noticed through the course of the day, in the second half, there have been quite a few points scored. Those adjustments made by offensive coaches at halftime have made those adjustments and been successful with it.
Yeah, I think that it's been a good football game. I think that both teams appear to be, doing the ball, moving things, doing well. And I would expect both teams to come out a little more settled and come in and try to run the ball just a little bit more to get going here.
Okay, because Aurora Christian's thrown the ball 27 times. That projects to an awfully big day for a right arm of Jordan Roberts. You're somewhat saying you're not so sure they can be successful consistently throwing in another 27?
They've got a 1,000-yard running back as well, and so obviously they've done some of those things. And I would look to see him try to mix in a little bit more run and try to get a little bit of the pressure off of him.
For Bloomington Central Catholic, they've lived by the balance all year.
They have, and man, I think their quarterback is going to be the difference maker. He has been so physical, not only offense, but how about that hit in the – that guy coming over the middle. He had some tippy toes the next time he came across, I'll bet you, because he got rocked.
It's a good one at the half here in your 4A state championship ballgame. Thanks to that late touchdown run by David Murray. Bloomington Central Catholic holding that narrow advantage. That breeze has been pretty constant all day long. The temperature has dipped a little bit after a sunny afternoon, and we have 24 minutes to crown ourselves a 4A state champion. Welcome back. I'm Dave Bernhardt. Let's take a look at our Honda halftime highlights. Happy Honda Days from your local Honda dealer, and we've got touchdowns galore. Number one, Bloomington Central Catholic. Dylan Johnson, 69-yard pass from Adam Rebholz. What a great run by Johnson. This capped a two-play, 67-yard drive, and it gave the Saints the early 6-0 lead. Then on the other way, Jordan Roberts. He's going to look for David Zilke, and there he is, right in the middle of the end zone. Extra point was good. 7-6 is the score. That was a 45-yard drive. Then on the other way, Bloomington Central Catholic, Adam Rebholz. Look at this. Quarterback run it. Two-point conversion pass was not successful. The Saints led it 12-7. Right on back we go. The very next play, David Zilke, 72 yards wide open from Jordan Roberts. Second touchdown connection for those two. The extra point kick was good, 14-12 AC. And then right here before the half, 17 seconds to play before half, thanks to the 35-yard pass to Ben Heaton. David Murray goes in from a yard out. And then looking for two, their first conversion of the day, and you get it for number 44. That is Murray again, and that takes us to our halftime score of 20-14, the lead for Bloomington Central Catholic. And as we look through those touchdowns, you realize in this first half, we had four lead changes. It hasn't been explosive, but they've been going back and forth at each other.
Yeah, a lot of quick strikes, too. A lot of one play, two play, big plays, maybe some blown coverages in there. I think that both teams need to settle in a little bit more defensively and try to find a way to make somebody drive and see if they'll make a mistake.
you know, and these are good defensive teams. Let's make no mistake about that. We talk about the quarterbacks and the offenses, but these teams get here, two 13-0 teams by virtue of some D as well.
Yeah, I agree. The defenses are really good, but the passing games that they're showing are so complex, and they're doing such a good job of using their rub routes and making sure that those quarterbacks are getting running yards if you're Bloomington Central Catholic, or the rub routes for AC. Those things are going to take hold, and I think it's going to be continue to be big plays.
You know, you make a great point as we take a look at the bigger picture. The sophistication of the passing game in high school football now is incredible. We'll see more of it tomorrow, but here in this 4A game, we're getting a load of it when you get to those wide shots as to how these offenses are integrated.
Yeah, you are, and I think that, you know, the higher you go, the more you're going to get. But, you know, it still comes down to blocking and the guys getting free, and then got a couple of great quarterbacks that are able to make plays out there, and I think that's the key.
Do you have a sense that it could come down to a couple of big plays, or do you think there's a – I mean, we've seen at BCC 100 yards advantage in total offense, but do you see it as a big play?
I do. I think that with number one being able to shake loose at any time, and then the big playability for sure with BCC, I just think that it's going to be kind of a tennis match here in the second half.
I think BCC needs to try to control the football by running it a little bit more and staying balanced. I think when they tried to throw the ball too much, I thought at times it kind of they stalled a little, but I thought it was better when they were pounding the ball up inside and then mixing in some pass. And I would look for them to be a little more balanced in the second half.
Earlier today, we saw some teams that were just much more physical than their opponents. Do you see anything in this game?
I think that BCC is more physical than Aurora. But like I said to you while we were talking, I think Aurora at all times kind of has that, in a boxing analogy, a puncher's chance. I think just at any time, they can drill you and hit one from end zone to end zone.
And I don't know that I disagree, but I also know that the styles are different.
Right, yeah.
You know, BCC's got a little more of that I formation, run the ball at you type of offense, which makes them appear to be a little more physical maybe. But, you know, I think Aurora Christian defensively has played some good football, and, you know, I would look forward to being an awfully good second half.
That's exactly where I was going to take you as we head to break. Second half coming up in your 4A championship game. Bloomington Central Catholic on top by 6 over Aurora Christian. Back with that second half right after this on the IHSA TV network.
And welcome back to Memorial Stadium in Champaign. Lee Hall, Greg Bradshaw, as we get ready to start the third quarter. Bloomington Central Catholic leads 20-14 over Aurora Christian here at the half. And you look at Jordan Roberts' numbers from the first half. Two touchdown passes, 153 yards, but they made him move around a lot. His percentage isn't very good at 10 for 27, but that I don't think matters.
No,
does it?
What matters is getting on the scoreboard. They've been able to get on the scoreboard twice with two big plays. And, you know, I think if you go come out of the locker room, if you're Coach Mays and you're Coach Beebe, you feel pretty good that you're in the football game. You feel you can win this game. Both teams really played a pretty decent football. Not too many big mistakes, but it was a good first half. I'm looking forward to a better second.
Downstairs to Scott Lever.
And Coach Beebe here with me. Coach, from a fan standpoint, that was an entertaining first half. What did you see, and what do you have to do to come out on top here in the second half?
Well, we got to be able to stop, you know, their run. They've been able to get some runs and take some time off the clock. So, and we got to tackle a little bit better. I think we had a few times there where we missed some tackles that we got to get them on the ground. So that's our plan.
You've seen a lot of good quarterbacks. You've worked with a lot of good quarterbacks throughout your life. What do you think of these two kids out here tonight, quarterbacking?
Fun to watch, aren't they?
Yes,
this is what high school football is all about, and I'm just glad I got the best seat in the house.
All right. Coach, good luck to the second half. All right.
Thanks.
Don Beebe, the head coach of Aurora Christian. Lee?
All right. Back upstairs here. Thanks a lot, Scott. Boy, you know a guy is committed to, and we see this from all coaches, committed to kids, committed to his faith, very much about his faith and what Aurora Christian is about as a community and a school, as a football program. And Don Beebe, you know, well-known football player and coaching. And, you know, you see that on the Central Catholic sideline as well, guys, that coach for not a lot of money out here for the love of the game and the love of the kids. There's the keys to the game for Central Catholic. And what do you think so far? How are they doing?
One of the things we talked about earlier is that they would take their run away. And really, Gaddis has not had too many big runs. They've done that. Rattle Roberts, they were able to get pressure on him. And there was a time in that first half that he was really out of sync. And then he had a couple big plays. Specialties, well, that's one of the problems they've got. They're one off on the extra points, really. It's 20-14. They can't afford any mistakes at the specialty game to make sure that you can finish the game and take this home. So you got to take care of this the ball during special teams. And here's Roy Christian. They want to keep Repholz in the pocket. They have not been able to do that. He's been able to get outside the pocket, make some big plays. They have been able. Roy Christian has had a couple home runs that we talked about, and they've got one big turnover that really kept them in the game in the first half. So they've been pretty successful at doing those things early in the first half.
One of the things Don Beebe said before this game was, you know, this is new for our team. He's like, it's kind of like Hoosiers. I need to go out and measure the hoop and show the kids that the football field's 100 yards long and nothing has changed as far as the game goes. And they've handled themselves pretty well here tonight, I think.
Yes, they have.
Van Gils with the kickoff. Heaton watches it bounce out of bounds. And it'll be a penalty against Aurora Christian here.
Dead ball, encroachment, kicking team. 5-yard penalty, re-kick.
Oh, that
actually,
penalty
that's
came.
A break.
Penalty came before the ball went out of bounds. That flag was back at the 40-yard line.
Yeah, that's a break. It's automatically, as soon as you go offsides, the ball is dead. And so that actually was a break. Central Catholic would have got the ball to 35. Now they got an opportunity where they can kick it deep.
Sounds like someone from England may have come up with a name for that penalty. Encroachment. You're guilty of encroachment. That will be 5 yards. And a re-kick. Pardon my encroachment, madam. This is fun. This is just fun. 2A state championship decided earlier. We covered that, and here we are with 4A bringing it to you. Here's Heaton. He'll catch it in his own 18-yard line, out to the 30, the 35, across to the 36, where he's brought down by a host of Aurora Christian Eagles. 20-yard return for Ben Heaton.
Always in a close game, the first score of the second half is really important. If Central Catholic can get one here, you know, get up two, or Aurora Christian can get right back in the game with a touchdown.
Eagles aren't used to being in this position either, Greg. The Richmond-Burton semifinal last week was the first time the Eagles have trailed in the second half since the first game of the year.
Right. And that first game was against our 2A state champion.
Immaculate Conception. Rebholz, the nice run on first down. He picks up 9.
Yeah, we talked about this in the first half. You get to the state championship game, you want to go with the horses that got you here. And the running game looks like it's falling on the shoulders of number 9. And he is very capable. Rebholz has really shown us he can run the ball and throw it through the air.
He said to us earlier this week, we want to leave our mark. This senior class wants to leave our mark on Central Catholic football, and it's a rich tradition, and they can add to it here tonight. Here's the give to Murray. He is close to a first down. But short.
A nice play there by Andrew Hubert. Bringing up the third and short here. Already a big play in this second half.
There's big Peter Kariotis, number 77, looking to make a stop here on third down and one in the opening moments of the third quarter. Here's Murray. Extra second effort gets the first down for the Saints. David Murray, the diesel, earlier this year in a 48-7 win over Olympia. Bobby Mays said after Murray went 3 rushes for 90 yards, 1 reception for 58 yards, and a 37-yard touchdown, I've got to find ways to get into the ball. Every time he gets the ball, he makes something happen.
Well, he certainly did there. Gaddis met him straight up in the hole. He was able to spin off, fall forward for the first down.
Ball at the 48-yard line. Backs in the eye. Rebholz fakes the handoff. Looks down the middle to Murray. Has him open at the 30. 25-20. Dragged down from behind at the 10 by David Silke after a pickup of 32 yards. 42 yards. Check that. 42-yard pickup, and it's a first down at the 10-yard line for the Saints.
Just a well-designed play, a little play-action pass. Murray lined up at the fullback position, slipped out of the backfield right down the seam, and Rebholz puts it right on the numbers. Great play. And he carries the defender another 10 yards. Just a great execution.
Right on cue. We talk about how he makes something happen. He does there. Here's Rebholz with it. Down to about the 6. bring up second and goal. They cannot get a first down.
This almost was disaster here. Low snap. Nice job by Repholz, and then a little stutter there and a fake. Able to get a few positive yards, but that was lucky. They were lucky they weren't get a negative play there. Bringing up second down and goal now in about the 6.5.
Bobby Mays says Adam Repholz is a great leader. Has him in their second straight state title game. Fake the handoff, the pitch and catch, complete touchdown to Drew Talkington, the tight end. And the Saints go up 26-14.
Another play action, again out of the eye, fake the give, good protection. Murray picks up the blitz. Nice catch by Talkington, good execution. Big score for Bloomington Central Catholic.
Our stats only include the top four receivers for Central Catholic, but that might be Talkington's first touchdown catch of the year. Cox the extra point. It's good this time, and it's a 27-14 Central Catholic lead after the touchdown for Drew Talkington. 27-14 back after this local timeout. Here's a look at Walgreens' Picture Perfect moment. Walgreens, a proud sponsor of the IHSA's Do What's Right Good Sportsmanship campaign. Saints cheerleaders on hand, liking what they're seeing here in our 4A state title game. Repholz, his second touchdown pass of the game, gives Central Catholic a 27-14 lead here with 9:17 to go in the third. Cox with the kick down into the corner. Morse has to field at that time, and a nice tackle there. Jess Heaton, the sophomore, Ben Heaton's younger brother, with a nice open field tackle. Six play drive for the Saints, 64 yards. Talkington, the 6-yard catch from Adam Repholz. Repholz with now 27 touchdowns on the year.
Yeah, he's having a great game. 12 of 15 on the day for 240 yards and 2 touchdowns. Almost perfect. Just really playing good football right now. It's a time to do it, too, in the state championship.
Big possession here for Jordan Roberts and the Eagles. They don't want to get down too far. Here's Gaddis with the catch. Out to the 20. He's got first down yardage and more. Out to the 29-yard line. Pickup of 16. Jordan Roberts to Lewis Gaddis. Don Beebe told Lewis Gaddis and his teammate Luis Solario, back when they were freshmen, he said, if you guys work hard and stick with this, you can be superstars. And Gaddis is just that for this Aurora Christian team as they play in their first state title game here tonight.
They're isolating Zelke down here at the bottom, one-on-one.
They go to him. He's open. It'll be a pickup of about 6, maybe 7, Heaton there on the coverage for the Saints.
Yep, they're just throwing short, and don't be surprised, they fake the short one and send Zelke deep one-on-one. They run that trips into the boundary, into the short side of the field, and then one-on-one with Zelke on the other side. Now they're doing it with Morse. Morse is up at the top of your screen all by himself with Ben Heaton on him, and all three receivers are down here in the bottom of the screen. Here they go, now they're looking
second
at the other
and
way.
Two. Incomplete. Morse was the intended receiver. Morse missed the first 4 games of the season for Aurora Christian. He had an enlarged spleen and liver after having mononucleosis. And Zelke was the go-to guy for Aurora Christian and Jordan Roberts.
Yeah, and that probably helped him, too, because then when Morse came back,
without a doubt,
Zelke really was a lot stronger and made their team better.
Third and two. To give to Gaddis, right up the gut, first down, out to the 43-yard line. That'll be a pickup of 7. Lewis Gaddis straight ahead. This is, Don Beebe says, our offense is kind of a mixture of West Coast and K-Gun that we ran in Buffalo, kind of a mix of that. 238 plays, and the thing about Jordan Roberts, who's been a starter since he was a freshman, he said, some of our calls are 2 sentences long, and Roberts has been able to do it since his freshman year.
It's like you got to practice with tongue twisters.
I mean, how smart do you have to be? I mean, that's incredible.
Yep. Well, it helps as you play as a freshman, sophomore, junior. Imagine now he could be running this offense. He's a coach on the field, and it shows in the decisions that he's making. and the throws that he's making.
Don Beebe says he's a Division I quarterback. So far, unsigned. First and 10 from the 43. Roberts to throw. Deep down the sideline to Zilke. Heaton with a great diving tip. He hits the ground hard again. Remember, he was on the turf earlier and had to get some attention, and he hit the turf hard again. But what a play by Ben Heaton. This was a touchdown.
We talked about this one-on-one with Zelke out there. Heaton, great extension of his body. Fantastic job getting all the way, just extending every ounce he's got, every inch of his body. Just lays out here and tips it with his fingertips. Otherwise, it's 6 points. Great effort there.
6 foot, 165-pound senior. He's on the turf again. What a great play. As Roberts and Beebe talk it over on the Aurora Christian sideline. Heaton's back up again, and he'll be escorted once again by Ashley Kingston, the trainer.
He might be cramping is what's going on, because he walks, he kind of gets up, and he's limping a little bit.
Yet he comes right back out. He bounces back.
Yep.
This surface is nice, but it's just a little bit harder than grass, regular turf. So that may take some getting used to. Second and 10 now for the Eagles. Looks again to the left side. It's Morse. He's got a first down. He's out at the 40-yard line. Pickup of 18 for Matt Morse. He's got some numbers that jump off the page at you, too. 55 catches coming in, 1,075 yards, and 19 touchdowns.
Nice timing route, just very simple. Down, go down 12 yards, turn out, and to deliver the ball on time to Morse. Again, isolating him one-on-one. Trips to the other side, one-on-one receiver to the opposite direction, and just throwing and catching.
Had four touchdowns in his first game back after missing the first four, like we mentioned earlier. Here's Gaddis up the gut. It's good for 4 or 5 yards.
Their run game is not, with so much imagination and creativity in the passing, the run game is very, very simple, but very effective. Just he lines up, Gaddis lines up straight behind Roberts, give to the right, give to the left, once in a while a trap, nothing fancy, but very, very effective.
7:10 to go, third quarter, 27-14 Saints on second and 5. Roberts back to throw, a little hitch route to Morse. Adam Curran with the tackle at the 25. Pickup of 10 and a first down.
Talked about rhythm earlier in the game. Right now, you just get a sense that this offense is in a little bit of rhythm right now. Off balance, keeping the defense off balance with the run, the short passing game, then trying to get the home run ball. This is Aurora Christian's offense at its best.
15 first downs for Aurora Christian, 14 for the Saints of Central Catholic. Eagles looking to close in.
Now they're doubling to the other side.
Roberts flushed out of the pocket and brought down. Sean Stokes, leading tackler for the Saints. Linebacker, we haven't called his name much tonight. He brings Roberts down there, and it'll bring up second and 9 for the Eagles.
A good adjustment there by Coach Mays. They now doubled the single receiver versus the opposite side with the trips now. And so to try to balance out the formation, they've been getting beat to that one single receiver side. You can see that at the top of your screen. Number 3, James Hendricks, is out there double covering now that receiver. Now watch them come down to the bottom of the screen likely now.
Trying to give Roberts different looks. He looks for Morse in the end zone. And it's a touchdown for Aurora Christian. 24-yard strike. Roberts to Morse. It's the third touchdown pass of the game for Jordan Roberts as he adds to his state record. Now 126 on his career. And it's 27-20. Van Gils on to kick the extra point for the Eagles. They look to get within a touchdown. It's up and good, and it's a six-point ball game with 5:54 to go in the third quarter. Saints of Central Catholic leading Aurora Christian back after this network break. Here's an easy one for you. Take care of some Christmas shopping very easily. Go to www.gametapes.com. Get a copy of this game in time for Christmas. Go to gametapes.com and see just how easy it is. You'll see those kids right there if you order that. I'm sure there's some mom and dads that'll be getting online for that. Heaton fields the kick at his own 10. Still on his feet at the 20. Now cuts back the other direction. He's covering a lot of real estate. Not going very far north and south, though. That was about a 100-yard run, and he gets 11 yards credit for it.
He did that earlier on a pass reception, and now he does it again. No wonder he's getting cramps. He's running all over the field.
In the words of Curly,
that's what it was like. My goodness.
He's going left, he's going right, he's going left, he's going right. The Saints will take over. Now their lead cut to six. They start at their own 21-yard line. Rebholz, 12 for 15. 240 yards and two touchdowns. The Saints quarterback under center, backs in the eye. The give is to Connor. We haven't heard much from him lately, and he's met at the line of scrimmage. Ryan Perrick, the linebacker, there to meet him for no gain.
Wow.
Actually a loss of two.
That's the way to come up and hit. What a great pop by Brian Perrick in the hole. Sees the lead, comes up, head in front, shoulder pad, right square in the midsection. What a great play by Ryan Perrick.
Don Beebe says he's a pro linebacker.
Wow.
He's just smaller. And we saw his hitting ability there.
He came up and made a nice pop.
Second and 12. Fakes the handoff. Rebholz, time to throw. Now flushed out of the pocket. He's going to have to keep it and run. He's out to the 25-yard line. It's a pickup of six. But after the loss, it'll bring up third and six.
Zach Koppel made a very big play. It doesn't seem like much, but one-on-one with Rebholz out in the flat there, was able to make that one-on-one tackle and prevent a first down and bring up third and long here. Big, big play out there in the open field by Zach Koppel.
Third and six for the Saints at their own 25-yard line, clinging to a six-point lead here in the third quarter. Here comes the rush. Rebholz gets it off. Curran stop running, and it goes over his head. If he'd have taken a couple of more steps, he might have had that.
Yeah, I think that wasn't his original intent to run outside. He was going out for a stop route, but the pressure brought out by the linebacker, they sent two linebackers on a blitz, and they were able to get to Rebholz, and he had to get rid of it early, and almost made a great play under pressure. But a big stop by the Eagles defense.
Drew Talkington back to punt. He had the touchdown catch earlier. It's Moore standing at his own 49, now at the 50-yard line at midfield. It's a high kick. Bounces near midfield and will stop there, and that's where the Eagles will take over. 25-yard punt. Just a slight breeze, but not very good yardage going right to left here tonight on the punts.
The punting games, have not been, they've not really been booming these punts. Get a good field position.
Some of the Aurora Christian fans on hand tonight. The school founded in 1975. They added athletics in 1977. Basketball, baseball, and cross country added in 78. Joined the IHSA in 88, and they just opened a new $1.2 million stadium this year, the first year they've had a home stadium.
It's beautiful, too. That field is fantastic. And
now they play for a state title here tonight. Roberts running left, running right, now running left, looking for a man intended for Koppel. The Eagles fans want interference, but they don't get a call there, and it'll be second and 10 for the Eagles.
Roberts bought himself some time, just enough, and then Adam McIntosh came right at the very end to put that pressure on. You'll see it right here in this replay. Actually, I don't know if we're going to get the replay, but a great job here. Here comes. No, it's not. We're going to see Roberts coming up to the line of scrimmage.
15 of 35 for the senior, but three touchdown passes. McIntosh was closing on him. The pass was intended for Gaddis, and Hendricks was there on the coverage for Central Catholic. Brings up third and 10. There's Don Beebe. He talked about Jordan Robertson. Thinks he's a Division I quarterback. He says, I think people overlook a kid's commitment to excellence, passion for the game, willingness to go the extra mile. He says Jordan has great character, wants to learn, and has the tools to be great. He's in the shotgun on third and 10. His team trails by six. Has a man, Koppel, hangs onto it that time. Rebholz caught him from behind, pickup of 12 and a first down for Aurora Christian.
Boy, Koppel's made two great plays. He made first that open field tackle on defense. Now he turns around, watch him go up for this ball, make a great catch under pressure, takes the hit, gets the first down. Those are the kind of plays that you remember when you play in this game, to turn around games, and two big plays, both on offense and on defense for Zach Koppel. It's that empty backfield again. Here it is again. This has been very successful with no backs in the backfield. This is when they've been able to get good protection, and he delivers strikes.
Roberts will try the draw now and goes for good yardage here. Has first down yardage, in fact, as he's finally brought down at the 26 after a gain of 12. Well, taking a page from Adam Rebholz's book there.
That's right, and he's fired up too. You can see it. He came after he got tackled. He got up, pumped his fist. He's excited. Here's another good look at it. Empty backfield, spread out the defense. And there he goes, breaks a tackle, some good blocking, lowers his shoulder, gets a few extra yards. Nice run there. Jordan Roberts, not what he usually does, but he can still tuck it under and go.
First and 10 from the 26, Aurora Christian on the move. Quick drop, Zilke can't hang on. Heaton was there in the coverage. David Zilke, the 5'10 senior, was the intended receiver. Couldn't hang on that time. And now it's second and 10.
Little cat and mouse game here again. Now he goes back to the one-on-one receiver. They're not doubling him now, so they try to take advantage of it. But good play by Heaton, one-on-one with Zilke. But the coaches are having a little bit of cat and mouse game right now on how they're going to play this coverage. Here they're going to bring out four wide receivers to the bottom of the screen, or to your right. Here you can see them at the bottom. There's one more out of your screen. There's only one to the top.
Interesting formation. Roberts rolls. Murray puts on the pressure. Pass is complete to Gaddis. Check that. That's Anderson. He's brought down at the 26 for no gain. Eric Anderson, the tight end, 6'1", 205-pound senior. Third and 10.
Third and 10 here, probably four down territory on the 26-yard line, so they don't have to get all 10 yards here on this down.
Adam McIntosh urging on the Saints fans in the stands just below us. Third and 10.
Looks like a little out to the top of your screen to Morse.
And a whistle before they can get going, and Aurora Christian will call timeout here. That's their first timeout taken. Bobby Mays looking on as Aurora Christian, 6 of 10 on third down. They've done a good job there.
Yeah, they have, and it looks like what they were setting up, I don't know if they'll come back out in it, but they had, again, trips to the short side, all the receivers into the short side, one-on-one at the top, and they had Morse kind of on a tight split, and he's been running an out pattern on that, so we'll see if they come back out and run that again.
You know, we talked about Don Beebe, and he talked about the win over Driscoll Catholic, said it's the best win I've ever been a part of. Now, that's hard to believe for a guy that won a Super Bowl with the Packers and went to six Super Bowls, but I think he really meant that. Well, I think he was really sincere, and, you know, coaching and watching your children and
right,
kids play, that it has a special meaning for
you.
Yeah,
it does, and they're not getting paid to do it. You know, that's the difference. They're out here because they love the game of football. They've invested their time on their own because they just love it. And then to have a big victory like that, that's really special.
Metamora and Wheaton St. Francis go after a state title tomorrow at 10, followed by Sacred Heart Griffin and Lamont at 1. 7A and 8A games to follow. Third and 10, big play here for the Eagles as they look to get even or take the lead. Pass is complete to the near sideline to Zilke.
Roberts pass complete.
Well, first down and 10 from the 14 now for the Eagles. Nice play that time to pick up the first down.
Great recognition by Jordan Roberts. They had, again, we've been talking about it the whole way, this cat and mouse game. This time they double covered Matt Morse up to the top, and he comes down, finds the one-on-one matchup, and delivers a strike for a first down. Just great heady play by Jordan Roberts. Great throw, great catch.
When he asked Don Beebe about his greatest on-field quality presence, he says, and he saw it there on third and 10, a big play. And now first and 10, looking to the corner, and it's just over the fingertips of David Zilke, incomplete. It'll bring up second and 10.
Good coverage there by Heaton. He's been busy all day. They've been working on him out there the whole game, and here you get another look at it. Just going to run a corner route, fake the slant, come back to the corner. Heaton right there with a little help from Hendricks. Hendricks right underneath. Good coverage.
Between coming off the field a couple of times, being hurt, the runs on the run backs, yep, running back and forth. He's put in a lot of mileage today as Ben Heaton. Here's Roberts. Faked the draw that time. Throws it out to Gaddis in the left flat. Murray is there and now has some company as Sherwood joins him for the tackle. And it'll be probably back to the line of scrimmage and no more that time as Roberts faked the quarterback draw.
Interesting play, fakes the quarterback draw, then tosses it back to Gaddis, and it really didn't develop real well, just well read by the defense, and for maybe loss, was that a loss of one or two, but good recognition by that defense, bringing up third down and 10 yards to go, yeah. Big play here.
7 of 11 on third down for the Roberts. Or for the Eagles, rather.
He is a lot of this
Christian
team.
Christian Roberts, yeah. He's got a lot of help out there. Here comes the rush by Central Catholic, and they drag him down at the 25-yard line. And there's Sean Stokes. We mentioned that we haven't talked about him a lot tonight. He's their leading tackler, star linebacker, and he comes up with a big play there to bring up fourth down.
Yeah, he did a great job. It was first to Adam McIntosh gets the pressure. It flushes him here. Almost gets him there, but he gets away. And there he comes. Sean Stoke coming in to put him away. And a big, big, big play on third down there.
Well, you can tell you're a quarterback. You're all nervous. The guy got sacked, and you're just all shook up, aren't you?
That's right. That's right.
We played three quarters. One more to go to decide the 4A state championship. Back after this local timeout. Lee Hall, Greg Bradshaw, 12 minutes to go here in Champaign to decide a 4A state champion. Central Catholic with a 27-21 lead over Aurora Christian. The Eagles on the move as we start the fourth quarter at the 25-yard line. Roberts to throw, looking deep, looking for Morse. Coverage there by McCracken, and he knocks it away. And Brendan McCracken, the 5'8". 180-pound senior is some kind of fired up. Here's a look at our stats through three quarters brought to you by Menards. Save big money at Menards. Look at the first downs for Aurora Christian. Passing yards, that's pretty good, almost identical.
Yeah, it's been a shootout here through the air. It's been a really, really exciting first three quarters. I think we're going to see a great finish to this football game. You can see the third down conversions there, both 50% or better. It's been an offensive show.
Central Catholic with the stop on fourth down. They take over on downs from their 25. And the Eagles jump. The question is, were they drawn?
Dead ball, encroachment, defense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
You've been whistled for encroachment. No tea or crackers or crumpets for you. 11:56 to go now. First and five for the Saints. Trips receivers to the right for Adam Rebholz. The senior quarterback for the Saints keeps it himself, has a lane, steps inside a would-be tackler out to the 50-yard line and into Eagles territory after a 22-yard gain for Adam Rebholz. 66 yards rushing now for the senior.
He's just such a threat through the air and on the ground. He's just a strong one. Great move there on Lewis Gaddis, one of the best tacklers for the Eagles. Just a great run, 22 yards. Real physical player at the quarterback position is Adam Rebholz.
Mentally tough young man. We'll get into that in just a second. First and 10 from the 48. Rebholz keeps it again. He gets running room. Look at him go. Good speed for the quarterback. Out to the 40. Now they mark him down at the 39-yard line. Pickup of 8. Scoreboard gives him 7 for 2nd and 3. This is a young man, Greg, who threw 3 interceptions and was sacked twice in the second quarter against Quincy Notre Dame. His team trailed 17-0. Bobby May said, he's my guy. If he threw 10 interceptions, we're going to keep throwing. Quincy had men up front. He recovered to throw for 335 yards, 2 touchdowns to go along with those 3 interceptions as the Saints came back from a 17-point deficit to beat the Raiders. Here's Murray up the middle. He'll be a little bit short of a first down, bring up 3rd and short.
As I mentioned earlier in the first half, you just sense that Adam Rebholz is playing just possessed. He really is fired up to play this football game, well prepared, well coached, and just doing a great job executing both the run and pass game tonight.
3rd and 1. He gives to Murray, and he has the first down. Well, talking to Adam earlier, he said, you know, we got down here last year, but it didn't seem like we did anything. I mean, we got to the state championship game. We didn't win. Didn't feel like we did anything. So they are really focused on this game. You know, Murray, who just got the first down, said, last year that was my first time in Memorial Stadium, and it was overpowering. Yeah. So these kids have been here, done that kind of thing, and they know how to prepare for it. It wasn't quite as an emotional week at practice, more businesslike, according to several of the players. 10 minutes to go now in the ball game. Backs in the eye. Rebholz back to throw, looking for Murray. He has the reception inside the 30, still on his feet. At the 20, they can't bring him down. He's at the 15, 10. Down at the 5-yard line, finally dragged down there by Braxton Warner after a pickup of 32 yards. The Diesel rumbles down to the 5-yard line and gives Central Catholic 1st and goal.
Nice job by Rebholz checking down. This was a check down to Murray. He looked downfield, no one open, and what a great option it is to get the ball to Murray as he just rumbles down the field, shedding tacklers left and right. What a fantastic run by Murray. He's had a great game tonight, both on the ground. He's had a couple of big receptions.
Here's the give to Connor. And that one flushed out well by the Eagles. Zach Koppel in there on the stop. And he probably lost a yard there.
Yeah, what a great play by David Murray.
David Murray runs pretty well for 5'10", 205. And he is, as we saw, tough to bring down.
Yes, he is. Determination.
2nd and 6. 2nd and goal from the 6, we should say. Rebholz to throw. Looking for Dylan Johnson and almost picked off. And if Morse would have gotten that one, it would have been 6. If Rebholz needed to put a little more air under that and give Johnson a little more leeway.
He looked wide open. He didn't see Morse. Morse was kind of hidden behind the line, and a great acceleration by Matt Morse. One more step, and he catches that ball. And it is 6 points, and we're going the other direction.
Only 11 interceptions for Adam Rebholz this season. Here comes the rush. It's complete to Murray. He slides down and probably lost a yard there.
That'll
bring up 4th and 6. And Kendall Cox will come out for the field goal attempt. He's 4 of 6 this season, 37 yards, his longest field goal make of the season. He'll be at the right hash.
Well, these are big points here to get it to 2-score game. They're only up 6 right now. Well, this would be big 3 points here for the Saints.
It'll be a 24-yard attempt. Rebholz is the holder. Snap is good. It's down. Kick is up. And it looks good, is good for Kendall Cox. He missed an extra point earlier in the game. It comes up with a big kick here to give the Saints a 2-possession lead, up 30-21 with 8:07 to play. We'll be right back on the IHSA TV network. Time now for our Buick Pontiac GMC Drive of the Game. Now's the time of the year to get great model year-end deals on our fuel-efficient cars, trucks, and SUVs. See your Buick Pontiac GMC dealer. They call him the Diesel, speaking of vehicles, and he is hitting on all cylinders tonight. David Murray with the great catch and run there. 32-yard pickup helps set up the field goal by Kendall Cox. And it's a 30-21 Saints lead with 8:07 to go. David Murray's father is a coach, a football coach, an assistant at Illinois Wesleyan University for Norm Esch, and is also our timeout coordinator on the field. I'm sure he's shirking his duties there and watching his son play. Morris brings it out to the 22, 16-yard return for Matt Morris. There's a look at the drive. Pretty good one there. 9 plays, 68 yards, 3:50, and a 24-yard field goal by Kendall Cox. Now 5 of 7 on the year for him. So Jordan Roberts and the Eagles take over at the 22, down 9 points. Plenty of time. Oh, and another big hit. Put on Zach Koppel. Who hit him? Was it Rebholz again? I think it was Heat. Adam Rebholz has been the one that's hit him pretty hard tonight.
Coach Beebe here was saying that that ball never hit the ground, and I don't know if it did, actually. It might have been an amazing catch, but they called it incomplete.
Brings up 2nd and 10. Low snap, Roberts throws it behind Matt Morris that time.
Yeah, that's too bad right there because they brought a blitz and they picked up the blitz. Roberts had time, just threw a little bit behind Morris. That would have been a big gain there on 2nd down if he could have delivered the ball. Put a little more pressure now on their offense. The fans are getting into it. Big play here, 3rd down, 10 yards.
Ball at the 22. Here comes the blitz. He gets out of it, running along the 20-yard line, looking deep. Has a man instead. It's Anderson at the 49, still on his feet. Sheds Heaton and gets into Central Catholic territory after a pickup of 30.
Big time play here.
Wow.
He feels the pressure. Buys time. Slides back out to the right. Presence of mind to look downfield. Finds Anderson. Makes a nice catch for a big gain. Big play there by Jordan Roberts and Eric Anderson.
7:30 to go and counting. Plenty of time in this ball game. No telling how many more scores we'll see. Gaddis, not much room there, maybe a yard. He's met by a host of Central Catholic tacklers. Joe Ring in there. And Bobby May says Joe Ring is dominant, forces teams to double and triple team him. That lets other guys run free. He is a whole lot of football player at 6'2", 245. That's Joe Ring. 2nd and 8. Roberts tries to run, and he's brought down behind the line of scrimmage or at the line of scrimmage, and I think it was Joe Ring on the tackle.
Yeah, Joe made a great play there. Just nowhere to go for Jordan Roberts. Hit a wall of white shirts. Again, bringing up 3rd and long. They've been able to convert, but it gets more difficult. The more you go in the game, the harder it gets at the end of the game to convert these long yardage situations.
Third and eight, has Morse, can't hang on. And as he tried to haul it back in, McCracken puts on a licking. Boy, these DBs for Central Catholic, they bring it and hit you pretty hard when you run across the middle, don't they?
Yeah, McCracken and Rebholz have had some big hits tonight. Here you get to see it. Little high, he goes up to get it, and here comes McCracken with a big crack on Morse. They're paying for it when they go across the middle.
I don't know that he would have hauled that in either at any rate, but McCracken made sure of it, didn't he? Fourth and 11. The Eagles 0 for 2 on fourth down tonight. They trail by 9 with 6:30 to play. Roberts gets it away. Flag. Falls incomplete. There's a flag on the play. It's on the near sideline. On fourth and 11, and it's against the Saints. Oh, big call there.
That was right along the Central Catholic sideline, so Coach Mays and crew got a good look at it.
On the defense, 10-yard penalty, fourth down.
So now it's fourth and one. Bobby Mays said at halftime, we saw some interesting things out there. I think that might have been his way of.
yeah, you don't get fined in the IHSA.
Saying something about the officiating, okay. And I'm sure he didn't like that call. Fourth and one, timeout. We hear somebody calling timeout downstairs. It'll be Aurora Christian with the timeout with 6:24 to go. They have fourth and one, trailing by 9. We'll be back after this local timeout. Defensive play of the game brought to you by the Illinois Army National Guard.
It's a great play by Heaton here.
Yeah.
That isn't Heaton. That's a Brandon McCracken making a big play on fourth down there.
Heaton made a pretty good one earlier too. On fourth and one, pass to Morse, caught. And a first down for the Eagles. First and 10 from the 27-yard line.
That's a big play on a slant pattern on fourth and one. I think most people here in the stadium thought they'd run the football. They run the slant. Great catch by Morse under pressure.
Do they have enough time? They trail by 9. Here's the give to Gaddis. He's wrestled down at the line of scrimmage and dropped for a loss.
Yeah, right now the run game really has been completely shut down by that defensive front. Here it is, another look again. Just a straight ahead, big Joe Ring there, making a good play, getting assisted there by Austin Sherwood. Really not much of a running game right now for Aurora Christian. You won't see much of that here on in.
Second and 12. Trips receivers to the top of your screen. Pressure, and he finds an open man down at the 12-yard line. Good for a first down. Losing his helmet is Zilke. 17-yard pickup. Zilke slow to get up.
It's a great throw. Doesn't have a lot of, just a good zip throw to Zilke, and a nice, great hit there by Blake Rave. Just an excellent hit, but a nice catch under pressure. Catch it, take the hit, get the first down. That's a big play, but he's paying for it.
Looks like he hit his head pretty hard on the turf as he came down, as they will attend to him. You know, we talked about the Central Catholic tradition. And as it strikes me is that we're standing here in the University of Illinois home stadium. Josh Brent, Michael Ho'omanawanui, former Saints players, now playing in the Big Ten for the Fighting Illini. We hope, of course, Michael's dad is an assistant coach on the Saints sideline. Let's go downstairs to Scott Leber.
Well, guys, what a job Don Beebe has done with the Aurora Christian program, but his sphere of influence goes well beyond Aurora Christian. He runs a House of Speed football academy that works with high schoolers throughout Illinois, and not only in the state of Illinois, but also four other states as well, developing speed, performance, and not only that, but also character and self-esteem. You've got to admire that. But his academy not only works with the high schoolers, they've also done some work with the Illini, the Bears, and the Rams. Although, the way the Rams are going, I'm not sure Beebe wants that publicized, guys.
Not going to claim that one. And you can see good news, David Zilke walking off under, well, mostly under his own power. And I think he banged his head after the hit. And,
right on the turf. You could see him slide here. There's his back across the field. Zilke makes the catch and bam.
Boom.
Well, I think it was just maybe from the hit. Just got jarred from the hit.
Either way, boy, he took his helmet off immediately. He knew. Holding his ears, almost like his bell got rung on that. Mm-hmm. Hopefully he'll be all right. Third, or make it first and 10 from the 12-yard line. Roberts back to throw. And complete to Anderson. Brought down as he caught it by Rave. Let's pick up a 5.
There's that 3-step drop from Jordan Roberts, just a quick passing game around the goal line.
And a whistle will stop things. They'll take care of a little housekeeping. And
something happened with the ball, looks like. Maybe got a little slippery or a little wet.
Nice.
Got to have a good ball when you're passing game like this. You can't have a slick ball. I know that. I used to pick them out before the game, about 5 or 6 of them, ones I liked.
It's all about the quarterback, isn't
it?
Under 5 minutes to go now. Roberts, there you see his numbers, 22 of 49, 315 yards passing, 3 touchdowns as well. Looking for another score here. Murray giving chase. The toss over the head of Morse. Touchdown. Nice over-the-head catch by Matt Morse. He's slow to get up. A 7-yard touchdown strike, the 4th of the game for Jordan Roberts. And it's a 3-point game.
Roberts throws this falling backwards right on the money, right over the shoulder to Matt Morse. Great catch, great throw. And just closing the gap. This game is never over, I don't think, till the final buzzer. Great job by that offense driving down. Jordan Roberts getting in the end zone.
Jake Van Gils for the point after. It's good, and we are now in a 2-point ball game with 4:50 to go in the fourth quarter. Back after this on the IHSA TV network. And Jordan Roberts has now set the 4A state record for most pass attempts in a title game, passing Dylan Ward of Prairie Central. And he's also set the record for yards, 322, the old record 305, passing Dylan Ward. We did that ball game.
Yes, we did.
Here's the kickoff. It goes out of bounds, and it'll be good starting position for the Saints at their own 35-yard line. Mistake there for the Eagles.
Dead ball, free kick infraction, kicking team. Ball placed at the 35-yard line, first down.
Those little things,
yep.
Those little things. Sometimes we thought when Cox missed that first extra point, it might come into play, and it still might. It's a 2-point game right now.
That's right. And, you know, right now, this defense has got to think a three and out right now, give that offense a chance to come back, and then, unfortunately, they got to start now on the 35-yard line.
Rebholz in the shotgun, trips receivers to the top of your screen. Quarterback draw, busts through the line, gets out to the 40-yard line. Good pickup by Adam Rebholz. His senior class never lost a home game.
Yeah, it's a great senior class, and they don't lose many home games at Bloomington Central Catholic. Here you see him running. He actually had a great opportunity to get out more, just got tripped up, but did get 5 yards, giving him second down and short.
And Quincy Notre Dame coach Bill Connell had great things to say about Rebholz after their game. He's taken great strides since last year, he said of Rebholz. Last year he stood in the pocket. This year he'll run around you, run over you. If I had an All-State vote, he'd get it. Well, he got enough of them to make the All-State team. Quick pass to Heaton. Check that. That's Connor. It's complete out to the 50-yard line. A pickup of 10 and a Central Catholic first down. And Bobby Mays and his staff not going conservative here. It's too early to go conservative. You have to keep playing your game.
Yeah, and they're putting the the game in the hands of their all-stater rep Holtz, and he's delivering right here. Just a quick hitter right off the bat. He knows he's uncovered, and you know, they're going to win and lose with the decision making of Adam Repholz, and he's making good ones.
And he has that ability to check at the line and change plays. He's given carte blanche by his coaches. He keeps it here, fights through a would-be tackler, and gets a couple of yards when it looked like he might be stopped in the backfield.
Yeah, he's just very strong runner, keeping the clock moving now.
What a staff for Bobby Mays. 132 years of coaching experience when you look at his assistants. Bud Conklin, 26 years. E.C. Ho'omanawanui, 13 years. Jim Malinowski, 15 years. His brother Mike, 21 years. Steve, his brother, Steve Mays, 17 years. 16 years for Mark Parker, and Bobby Crawford's been there since 2001. Some great coaching experience. Repholz going for it all to Dylan Johnson. Can he catch up to it? He does! He steps out of the 11-yard line, a pickup of 37 yards. Repholz make it 38 yards. They mark him out at the 10. Dylan Johnson with another big catch for the Central Catholic Saints. He had the first touchdown catch of the night and a big one here in a two-point game with under 3 minutes to go.
What a throw by Adam Repholz. Just throws it up over the shoulder, over the outside shoulder, right into the hands of his receiver, Johnson there. Not bad coverage, just excellent throw and catch.
He got a really good spot because he stepped out at the 12. What do you think about him as a quarterback? You've played Division I football.
I really like him. He's the hometown of Illinois State. I know they could look for a quarterback. I think he's a great athlete, great decision maker, and he's really got a big-time arm.
Connor's got room to run. Down to the 2-yard line for Brad Connor, the sophomore.
34, Brad Connor, the ball carrier.
He came into this game with 14 touchdowns, an average of 4.7 yards per carry, and boy, he had room to run. Great blocking, a great lane for Connor on this one.
Good misdirection in the backfield, gets down to the 2-yard line. Just a great drive when they really needed it here in the fourth quarter.
Connor just 23 yards rushing. Repholz leading the way on the ground with 80 yards rushing for the Saints. Second down, 2 yards to go for the score. Murray, not much room, gets a yard off the left side.
Repholz doing a good job right now, realizing the time is the biggest enemy of Aurora Christian. He's running the play clock down to about 2 seconds before he snaps the ball. Real heady, smart play by their quarterback.
That's Dave Beebe, Don's brother and defensive coordinator. The Saints clinging to a two-point lead, trying to possibly put it away here, but you have to say that with, you can't say that yet with this Aurora Christian team, with their offensive ability to strike in a heartbeat. Repholz in the shotgun, third and one. Takes it himself. Look at him go through a would-be tackler. He was practically caught at the 4, but he gets in for the touchdown, and Central Catholic takes an 8-point lead. Adam Repholz, what a game.
We've seen it all night. Here it is again. Makes a big strip. It gets out of the tackle, the arms there. A big number 7-7, Kariotis, and gets into the end zone. Great individual effort by Adam Repholz. Big time player having a big time night.
And what a, you know, adding to an arsenal of a quarterback. Cox, the kick is up and good. 37-28, now a 9-point lead. To be able to throw with the pinpoint accuracy he can, and then to have that running game there, you have to respect both, and it's tough to defend.
Yeah, he's done a great job. A lot of strength. You could see him just breaking tackles.
Yeah.
He's been determined all night. You had that look in his eye. We saw that earlier. He does not want to be denied this state championship, and he's played excellent, excellent football. 319 yards through the air, 81 on the ground, 2 touchdowns passing, 2 touchdows rushing.
He's 6'2", 200 pounds, and he can run like a bull. There you get a look at the Prep Bowl championship score. And a state championship about to be decided here, a minute 28 to go, 37-28. Bobby May still not very satisfied with the gentleman wearing the striped shirts. And there you get a look at the numbers. Another record, passing yards, total 641. We did that Driscoll Catholic Prairie Central game back in 2003, and they lit it up that night, and they're 100 yards better than that here tonight.
Yeah, both of them have set the previous record is 305 yards,
they both have broken it
tonight.
Rebholz 319, Roberts 322. And it's Rebholz team with the lead, a 9-point lead with a minute 28 to go. And what a sweet finish to a painful emotional season this would be for the Saints. There's a squibber picked up at 30 by Gaddis. Down at the 36-yard line. A minute 24 to play. There's a look at the Central Catholic drive. 7 plays, 65 yards. Boy, Adam Rebholz did a little bit of everything on that drive,
yeah,
too.
He
completed some good passes and ran it in for the score.
They went for the juggler. They did not sit and just start running the ball, try to run out the clock,
right,
and then have to punt it away. They were very aggressive and, again, made Rebholz make the plays, and he did just that.
So a minute 24 for the Eagles and Jordan Roberts. He has a man. It's Koppel. He's brought down at the 40-yard line. Stays in bounds. The Eagles have just one timeout left. They had to use two timeouts earlier, and that could come back to bite them here.
Right.
Down by 9. Minutes 6 and counting.
They're just going to give them those 5-yard gains.
Down the middle to Morse. He's into Central Catholic territory and brought down by Rebholz with 56 seconds to play. Gain of 13. We talk about the heavy hearts of the Central Catholic Saints. We talked about Dylan Johnson's father. We'll talk more about that here in just a moment. 55 seconds to go. Roberts running out of room and running out of time. Incomplete flag on the play. They're going to get a late hit.
Intentional grounding, actually, they're going to call. There's nobody out there, so that's going to be, intentional grounding.
McIntosh was there on the pursuit for the Saints. Don Beebe looking on as his team has whistled for the penalty.
Intentional grounding, offense. 5-yard penalty, from the spot of the foul, loss of down, second down.
Central Catholic, 7 penalties for 65 yards. Aurora Christian, 4 for 25, and Central Catholic has overcome that to lead here by 9 with under a minute to play in our 4A state championship game. The Saints trying to become the first team to win state championships in 4 different classes. That pass intended for Zilke is incomplete.
Yeah, I'm just impressed that Zilke's even back in the game after that hit that
he
took. I didn't think he'd be back, but he's out there just showing his courage.
And Don Beebe talked about him. He said, since I've been at Aurora Christian, he's had the biggest transformation from his junior to senior year. He came from out of nowhere, baffled at how good he's become this year. 3rd and 26. Murray with the coverage. He'll be flagged for that. Flag from the back judge. He'll be whistled for pass interference.
Here you see Koppel going down the middle. You can see the arm. Yeah, the arm draped all over him on the left side. Left arm draped over his shoulder. It's automatic first down.
Pass interference on the defense. 15 yards from the previous spot. That will be an automatic first down.
Bobby Mays looking on, 39 seconds to go. Can the Eagles pull off a miracle? That's what it would be here, down 9 with under a minute to play. The pass is complete to Zilke. He's out of bounds at the 30 with 35 seconds left. This has been a well-played, exciting, fun game to watch.
Yes, it has been. You like offense, you like good quarterback play, this has been a game
for
you.
I do. First and 10 from the 30. Roberts. It's Silky again, and a nice shoestring tackle by Heaton to keep him in bounds. And the Eagles will take their final timeout with 29 seconds to play. Zilke, 9 catches, 155 yards. That's a new 4A title game record.
Yeah, he beat out my receiver from 1983, my friend Dean.
Oh, no.
He had 8 passes. You know what? That record stood a long time, my buddy Dean going down.
And 155 yards, is that a record as well?
Nope.
Receiving?
No, Greg Turner. Yeah, remember Turner, 210
yes.
yards.
Most completions in a title game, 27. Boy, Dylan Ward was a good quarterback. We remember him well from Prairie Central.
Aurora Christian's going to try the field goal here and get the points and then come back and kick the onside kick, give them an opportunity to win the football game.
His long of the year is 43. This will be a 39-yard attempt. Out of the hold of Roberts. He's got enough leg, but it's no good left. And the Saints celebrate on the near sideline. You can hear their fans, 29 seconds left before they can claim the 4A state title. And you can see on the side of Bobby May's hat, Big Bob, his father. We lost him about 3 years ago. We talked about him during last year's game and how they wish he could have been here for that. And boy, would he have liked to seen this. 26 seconds away from a state title. They won their first one back in 82 under John McIntyre in 2A. Finished second the next year. In 87, they won the 1A title under John McIntyre as Bobby Mays better get prepared for a shower. Bobby Mays won a championship in 94 in 3A. And they are going to crown a new champion in 4A here tonight. They were second a year ago to Driscoll Catholic. There's another record. Total yards both teams for a title game. As time will run out on this 4A state championship game, and the Saints of Central Catholic will bring a state championship home to Bloomington. Bobby Mays in his 17th season as head coach with his second state championship. Enjoy the shower, coach. Woo, that feels good.
Ooh, he got the real deal. He got the Gatorade.
He got the Gatorade, yes,
indeed.
He's
got the stickiness and all. He doesn't care.
Adam Rebholz, what a game, Greg. 16 for 21, 319 yards, 2 touchdowns, no interceptions.
That's right.
And 80 yards rushing and 2 touchdowns on the ground.
In addition to that, defensive backfield, he was an intimidator back there. He made some huge hits early in the game to kind of set the tone for their defensive backfield. They were physical all night with those receivers from Aurora Christian. Fantastic job. Congratulations to Adam Rebholz and the Central Catholic Saints. Great job tonight. Well-deserved, well-played game. They played Aurora Christian, played very, very well, but not well enough.
Let's go downstairs to Scott Leber.
With Bobby Mays, congratulations, Coach. I know last year some unfinished business. The outcome against Addison Driscoll, not what you wanted, but the guys got it done tonight. Describe your feelings right now.
I'm so happy for these seniors. These kids have really put a lot of time and effort into it, and they've been so fun to coach, and it's been a great year, and they deserve this. They really do.
The state of Illinois didn't know about Adam Rebholz before tonight. They sure do now. What a job he did for you.
He's an outstanding quarterback, and I keep hearing about all these other quarterbacks. He's as good as all of them.
Dylan Johnson, what about the game he had? And I know it's been a rough year for Dylan.
Dylan, you know what? He's been a playmaker for us all year. Made big plays. He turned that first pass into a big long gain. Had some nice plays on defense. Had a little tough time. His dad passed away. But, boy, I'm sure his dad is really, really enjoying it now.
The Mays family going to do some celebrating tonight.
Oh, I think we'll all celebrate tonight.
Congratulations, Coach.
Thanks.
Guys, back to you.
Thanks, Dave.
All right. Thanks a lot, Scott. Yeah, we talk about the heavy hearts. It's been a tough year at Central Catholic. Dylan Johnson lost his father, and that was before the season started. And then just a couple of weeks ago, the development director at the school, a guy known as Mr. CCHS, Chuck Schanneberger, passed away on November 11th. So they've played with heavy hearts at times, but nothing but celebration tonight as the Saints win it 37-28 to bring home the fourth championship in school history. 2A champs in 82, 1A champs in 87, 3A champs in 94, and now 4A champs in 2008.
Yeah, that's pretty impressive, and a good team effort all around. David Murray, number 44, just did a great job today in his fullback position, both running the ball, big runs, and some great catches. On defense, I'm really impressed with Adam McIntosh. Just got pressure all night onto Jordan Roberts. In the defensive backfield, you got to take your hat off to Ben Heaton. Ben, a couple times he was down on the turf. I think he had cramps, but he just kept playing very, very hard, made some great plays. All-around great effort by this team.
Uh-oh, I see another Gatorade shower on the way. I'm not sure who that's for. They tracked down Mays again. Well, I went to college with a bunch of guys from Central Catholic, and it's a great community and a great school, and congratulations to them. Scott Leber is with our Country Insurance and Financial Services Player of the Game. I'm guessing it's Adam Rebholz.
That's right, our Country Financial Player of the Game, Adam Rebholz, the quarterback of the Victoria State Champions. Adam, super job out there tonight. Were you expecting a shootout with this great offensive Aurora Christian here?
Well, we know they had a good high-powered offense, so I think our defense, they had some big plays, and you know, it ended up being a shootout, but we came out on top.
I don't know what I was more impressed with, your quarterbacking or those couple big hits you had there on the defensive side of the ball. How much do you like playing defense?
Oh, I love playing defense. I hate being off the field is what I hate more.
Well, this is four state championships in four different classes for Bloomington Central Catholic. What's it like to be a part of this program?
It's big. I mean, we made history. I've just been saying this whole year that, you know, if we go undefeated, that's a record that can't be beaten. So, but we're going to get a picture up on the wall and be remembered Central Catholic.
College coaches and scouts were watching tonight. They had to be impressed. What are your future plans?
I hope so. I don't know yet. We'll see. But now that season's over, I can hopefully work that out.
All right. Congratulations on your state championship. That's Adam Rebholz. Guys, back to you.
Well, he said last year it didn't feel like we did anything. We came down here and finished second. And he also said we wanted to leave our mark on Central Catholic football. And this team did that, 14-0 state champions in Class 4A. Our congratulations to Aurora Christian, and just the fifth season for Don Beebe there, and he has started a tradition that I'm guessing we will see more of these guys in the future.
Yeah, they played very, very well. They have a great scheme offensively. It looks like a really fun offense to play in, and just a great job all year. They had some tough games in the playoffs that they won. Obviously, they took the defending champion Driscoll down in the quarterfinals, which is a huge game for them. Just a great year, and really they should be proud of their season.
Second young man from the left there, Ryan Perrick. He said last week, I just can't imagine the thought of eating Thanksgiving in Champaign. I always watch the games on TV just thinking, I wish I was there. Well, You're there, young man, and congratulations on the second place finish. It's one of those things, and we say it every year, it hurts now, but from now, a couple years from now, 20 years from now, they will look back with a lot of pride on what they were able to accomplish at a school that's only been around since 1975.
Yeah, they've done a lot there in the football program. They put themselves on the map this year, and they'll have a lot of kids in Aurora now thinking, hey, you know what, I might want to go play football over there at that Christian school. I really appreciate the way they handle themselves, just great character kids. They certainly handled themselves well today.
Don Beebe, 9 NFL seasons, and now his first trophy as a head football coach at Aurora Christian. They came within 6 points of playing for the 3A state championship here last year, and that was kind of a rallying cry for this team all year. And they had some really close, tough games, and You know, the defense, we talk a lot about Jordan Roberts tonight, but Don Beebe says our defense won a lot of games for us this year, maybe more than our offense. And I said, that's kind of hard to believe, Coach, but you look at the close games that they were in this year. You know, they came back and beat Immaculate Conception 22-12. They beat Mendota 10-6, six-point win over Walther Lutheran. You know, the nine-point win over Richmond Burton last week. And there you get a look at the Central Catholic Saints. And they have nothing to be proud of, that nothing being in the loss column.
That's right.
14-0. Nobody will beat it. And we talked about the new stadium over at Aurora Christian. Central Catholic built a new school in the last few years. A beautiful football facility. They've done great things in Bloomington at Central Catholic High School. It was a school like Aurora Christian that didn't have much in the way of facilities. They called the basketball gym the pit, lovingly. They did not have their home field moved all over town. Now they've got a field they can call their own, Bill Hundman Memorial Field. And a great job by Bobby Mays and his staff. Duck Gadkins there, the athletic director. And there's David Murray, who had a whale of a game.
Yes, he did.
Here tonight. 65 yards rushing, 71 yards receiving, a touchdown.
Dylan Johnson there, Dylan Johnson, Joe Ring. It's a great group of seniors. Just a great job. There's Dan Curran.
Dan Curran. There is Adam Rebholson. Just talking to him last week, just realize how much there's Sean Stokes, how much that young man, Adam Rebholz, has matured in the last year. He really came into his own this year. Ben Heaton, a yeoman effort out there. And Bobby Mays, his second state championship as head coach.
And here comes the hardware. There it is.
That's a great feeling, isn't it? Wow. Congratulations to the Central Catholic Saints. The Saints go marching in as your 4A state championships. And Adam Rebholz talked about the camaraderie of the senior class and how proud they were of what they've done. They hang out together after the game and talk about how much that helps them mesh and blend and play together on the field, and it's brought them a state championship here tonight. Congratulations to both teams here tonight. Well played, fun game. Greg Bradshaw, thank you. We'll be back right after this local break, followed by a network break.
Dylan Johnson is with us, receiver for the state champion Bloomington team. Dylan, first of all, describe that opening touchdown you had that kind of set the tone tonight early.
Well, Adam had a little rollout. I think he had some pressure from the backside. He was just able to throw it up. I had to go up a little bit and get it, and I had some great downfield blocks by, I think, Dan Curran and Ben Heaton, and I was able to fortunately shed a tackle, and then the rest was to the end zone. I was feeling that wind gone for a couple series after it too, because I was giving it my all, and it was just a great experience. I guess a way to set off the game, but
it was a heck of a run after the catch. Now it's great to see you smile, because I know it's been a rough year for you, losing your dad. Have you thought a lot about him tonight?
Oh, every time I wear this armband with his initials on it, and just whenever we're struggling on the field, I find myself looking at it and you know, just saying, come on, Dad, give me a little help. And he sure has been there with me all year, and I know he's smiling down on me right about now.
Congratulations. Go get your picture taken.
Thank you. Appreciate
That's Dylan Johnson, Lee.
Thanks a lot, Scott. Boy, I'm sure his dad would be very proud of that young man tonight. Here's our Menards stats. Save big money at Menards, 37-28, the important number. Aurora Christian, a lot of first downs, and there you see a look at some of the other numbers, 5 of 9 on third down, 8 of 14 for Aurora Christian. Time of possession, pretty close right there. And Central Catholic with the 37-28 win, just one turnover in this game. There you get a look, passing yards, unbelievable passing yards tonight.
A lot of big numbers.
A lot of offense. Almost, 900 yards of offense?
Yards, that's
oh,
right.
My gosh. A lot of penalties, too, but Central Catholic overcame that tonight to win. And that picture will go up on the wall at Central Catholic and be forever remembered. Let's take a look at some of our Honda postgame highlights. Happy Honda Days from your local Honda dealer. Jordan Roberts here.
This was a great play, just falling backwards, throws the ball up to Matt Morse, right over the shoulder. Great catch here in the second half, bringing them back into the football game.
One of his four touchdown passes on the night. Adam Rebholz, what can you say about the night? Hey, look at how strong a runner he is to be able to pull his way into the end zone. Two rushing touchdowns, two passing touchdowns tonight for Adam Rebholz as the Central Catholic Saints win it. 37-28, they become the first team to ever win a state championship in four different classes. The 4A state title goes to them tonight. The IHSA TV network returns tomorrow with championship play beginning at 10 a.m. with Wheaton St. Francis and Metamora. And there's Bobby Mays getting the old school Gatorade
That's
shower.
Right.
Yeah.
The real thing.
Loving every minute of it. 37-28, Greg Bradshaw, always a pleasure. I'm Lee Hall. So long from the campus of the University of Illinois, Champaign-Urbana Memorial Stadium, state championship for the Saints. So long. We'll see you tomorrow from Champaign.